Hello. The episode you're about to listen to is from our Lost Episodes series. It's from when we were still figuring things out, so it may contain errors, jumps, cuts, audio, or just poor quality. That being said, enjoy.
Thank you. Are we alive?
Hi, welcome to Friday Night Bible Studies.
Welcome to Friday Night Bible Studies.
Hey, everybody.
And welcome to Friday Night Bible Studies.
That's your host, Carolyn, the Rock Ramella, DJ. Who can only think of visual.
Oh, I remember my DJ name
it's
from
playing my next
year.
Song.
DJ Justin the Rock.
Oh,
fuck. Shit. I gotta go. No, just kidding. DJ Justin the Rock Bieber was my DJ name for a while. So that's me. And then we are also joined with...
By the way, if you like those sick tunes...
No, yeah, that's a good...
You can get my sick tunes at my SoundCloud.
That's DJ Sellout.
I have...
Trying to sell out.
A SoundCloud.
But the S is spelled with a dollar sign.
Of course.
Because he sold out to capitalism.
Next person.
Dr. Nurse. MD. And I'm DJ... I'm presidential candidate Bernie Sanders.
No, we're saving that for a later episode because I'm going to advertise on my Facebook like everyone.
We can't let them know our secret. Just kidding, you can know all our secrets.
Everybody knows. Everybody knows that it's our joke now. We can't do it anymore.
We can do it.
Anyway, this is our first segment of Friday Night Bible Studies. We're gonna ask questions for God. First question. Hey God,
why do we suffer?
What happens to emus when they die?
Why do we suffer?
See, I think emus go to emu heaven.
I think they go to dog heaven.
Yeah, why are you saying emus like dogs
simply,
in Japanese?
Simply for the irony.
Kellen, do I know Japanese?
Inuyasha is because he's like a dog man.
I think I'm turning Japanese.
Expert in Japanese, Carolyn?
That's a song about
I don't know. I thought maybe you watched Inuyasha.
I didn't.
Okay.
So,
Pete? The
only person who's ever watched Inuyasha.
Oh.
That might be true. Actually.
Ever. Yeah.
What is playing? I don't know.
What was the problem?
I hear music. Like a drum beat.
Oh my God.
It's not me. Of all time.
So, we it's have an exciting show tonight.
Okay. What are we doing?
We're going to stab
guys
someone.
Face painted.
I am. Classic visual comedy, Carolyn.
And Aiden's going to be the one painting it.
Ooh. But he's going to use his feet instead.
This
won't that be wacky to watch?
My Bible studies is called What Would My Mama Do? Where we take questions from you, the listeners, and I tell you what my mama would do.
Wait, can I say something that my mama did today?
Okay, what's your mama do?
I was calling her about the FAFSA, and there's like a question.
The what?
The FAFSA.
The what?
Shut up. And
FAFSA.
Shut up.
You guys and should fight each other.
There, I will. And there's a question that's like, how much like money do you have in your accounts and stuff? And so I was asking this to my mom, yeah. And she's like, shit, hold on, I gotta go empty my accounts.
What? I gotta go empty my accounts?
Yep.
What is that?
All right, hold on. I understand what's happening right now, like from like all perspectives.
So okay, explain.
So you empty your accounts so that it looks like you don't have any money.
Yeah.
So that then, you know, when you file, it's like, oh, we need all the money because we don't have any, and you just have it, you know, in like gold bullions in your underbed. It's 1,000,000,000.
Oh, okay. I didn't realize it was a number.
Yeah.
Quality.
Well, this
like
is a woman who I learned my moral
is like an ingot.
Oh, okay.
Who I learned my moral code from.
Not just your mom though, right?
Also, my mom.
Yeah.
Greg's mom too.
And Connor's mom,
which is weird because it's like halfway across the country.
Don't
bring that up.
Yeah. I'm sorry. Greg, you made an interesting remark. You said you can see this from all perspectives.
All perspectives.
What would a Tibetan monk have to say?
Oh, every. I like this.
When one sits in a room and tells jokes, who is being told?
Greg, what would the great cosmic owl say in response?
Who?
The Great Cosmic Owl?
Who?
It's a character from Adventure Time because yeah, Connor is
saying who. Oh, shit.
You've got to be fucking kidding me.
What would like pre-scandal Bill Cosby say?
Well, that sounds like a pretty good idea. It's a funny joke. It's a good joke. Puddin' Pops.
If you're listening back at my home place and you want to ask a question for what my mama would do, just email us at 6983@hotmail.com.
Because that's what Connor's mom does. She's 69.
She 83s, which you don't want to know what that is.
I shouldn't have said 69 at all. All right. From now on, you know we're never going to say 69 again. We're never going to say 420 again.
Connor. No, we're going to have to say it again.
If you actually want to email us, feel free to
do we have an email?
No.
FNBSradio.
We actually
do you, oh email, my god, please. Okay, what is the
if
email?
If you want to tweet at us,
no,
tweet at us at FNBS Radio. It's all the same. Or is it?
I think we should play an improv game to warm things up.
For sure.
Aidan, what's your favorite improv game?
My favorite non-visual improv game.
No, I want visual.
Yeah.
I mean, well, Carolyn wants visual.
I think my favorite non-visual improv game to play is I Like My Women. Do you not know that
this
game?
Sounds like it's good.
Do you not know?
I don't,
misogynistic.
I don't know the word.
Probably racist.
It can be I Like My Men as well.
Oh, okay.
What about non-binary people or people? Yes.
Can I say I like my person?
Yeah.
I mean, that sounds like slavery.
Yeah, so it's pretty simple. It'd be like, I like my women like I like my coffee, black. Or I like my women like I like my coffee, filled with my cream.
No,
I like my women so, like I like my coffee.
Coffee? No, anything.
That's anything?
That's black.
That's the improv part. So, like, let's say an object, and then
okay. If you want a specific object for us to like women like, email us at FNBS. Okay, wait. What is it?
Friday Night Bible Studies. FNBS.
FNBS.
Radio.
Radio.
Be easier if Greg just made the announcement
at gmail.com.
Him relaying the information. Okay, well,
let him say it. Let him say it with no one talking.
All right. I'm going to relay the information. FNBSradio@gmail.com.
Okay, why don't we plug the Twitter?
At FNBSradio.
On Twitter.
Fancy that.
Oh, wow, you got some good handles. At FNBSradio wasn't taken already.
Nobody wants letters.
Everyone wants
just in
letters.
General,
that's
nobody,
all Twitter
nobody
is
wants
letters.
Letters. That's false.
It's letters
pictures.
And characters and emojis and numbers.
And
emojis
feelings.
Emojis
so
are Unicode characters. They are not letters. Numbers aren't letters.
Right. So how do we like our women? Carolyn, do you want to...
What's the topic?
We should give objects for everybody.
Do we have a thing?
So Carolyn has to like women like she likes sticky
I'm also
pads.
The only one like eating
like
the mic, so I'm the
notes?
Only one people
you
can
post-it notes as well. Okay. Man.
I like my woman like I like post-it notes because they come in a lot of different colors because I love woman regardless of race. And I think it's important to not view, to view race in regards
I like
of
my
like,
woman like I like my post-it notes disposable.
I like my woman like I like my post-it notes sticky on the top.
I like my women like I like my post-it notes approximately 1 inch by 1 inch or 2 inches by 2 inches,
wait,
depending
Connor,
on how much I need to write.
Connor, what's about being sticky on the top?
Yeah.
No,
do you use sticky notes the wrong way?
You try to
stick them
no,
right on the
like,
part with the sticky side and then you fold them over?
The
is that
vertical
what
side. Like,
yeah, but how are women sticky on the top?
You put glue on their hair.
Fribel night Biden studies.
Fribel dibble dib dib.
You guys know why.
No, I don't.
You never given a pearl necklace?
I taught you what that was.
Yeah, she's... And has that not exactly what a sticky note is?
I mean,
but
a sticky note and a pearl necklace are two different
on
things.
You're
if
kind
you,
of implying that she's
married,
not properly lubricated, which means she's not properly aroused, which means she's
stop
not having a good
talking
time.
Oh my God.
If you're married
you
and you get
about
your wife...
I'm talking about how to pleasure
a
woman.
Of a pearl necklace, I think you're going to find yourself with a divorce. Just throwing that out there.
Not properly lubricated. What are you talking about?
Because when a girl is sexually excited, her vajayjay gets wet.
I mean, top of her body.
Yeah.
Guys.
Like you.
Yeah, wait. I was really on your side. Now I'm totally on Connor's
side. Wait, Aidan, what were you thinking?
Well, okay. So he
head
said
vagina.
The sticky on top thing, and I had no idea what that meant.
Okay.
And then he was just like, oh, yeah, it's a pearl necklace. And I was like, all right, that was kind of.
Okay.
It's a little unclear to me, but yeah, I get that.
But it sounds like your vagina is not properly.
Clear. No, I wouldn't do that.
You wouldn't get a girl aroused before you have
no,
sexual intercourse.
No, I wouldn't.
Ew, gross.
All right, I want to not talk about this.
For viewers at home, Connor's face is as red.
Red as a beet.
Red t-shirt, and he's just blending
you
in.
Y'all think I'm a sexual deviant. I'm not a sexual deviant. I'm a sexual Protestant.
I mean...
Greg, you like your woman like you like clouds.
I like my women like I like my clouds. White and above everybody else.
That's so good.
I like my women like I like
oh,
my
no!
clouds.
Oh no.
I'm fine.
I'm fine. That's it, what you get,
cracks,
Greg.
It cracks into oh, place. No, no. So it's good for now.
For listeners at home, Greg has it.
I broke my elbow.
Yeah.
Not just not right now. Earlier.
Yeah.
And you just re-injured it.
No, I fixed it.
Wait, who is saying what?
Yeah. I like my women like I like my clouds. Drizzling wet.
See, Aidan knows how to...
I like my women like I like my clouds. I get up in a plane and I see them with salt so that it rains and my crops will grow.
You see them with salt?
Yeah, that's what you seed clouds. You gotta seed clouds. They make it rain. But at the Geneva Convention, they made it illegal to control the weather, which is like totally like, could you imagine if we fought wars by like controlling storms and shit?
Wait,
that would be
that'd
freaking
be really cool.
Amazing.
You
know,
I
like,
didn't know you could
freaking
make
super
clouds
genius.
Rain.
Yeah. Absolutely.
What do you mean by seeding?
Because like the way that rain forms is that there's particles in the air and the water particles attach to those and then they all glob together. So if you like throw stuff into the cloud,
what do you throw?
Like salt.
You just throw salt. Like if I took salt on a plane.
Yeah, and you punched the window open.
No, it would be a plane that I could open a window.
It would be like Snoopy's plane.
Yeah, that's the exact plane
I mean,
I'm thinking of.
It might
type of plane.
It might not be like table salt, but I believe it is some kind of ionic thing that can, you know, be.
There's a lot of salts in the world, and a lot of them are poisonous. For those of you listening at home, make sure you know what kind of salt you're putting on your French fries.
Eggs. Oh. But so yeah, you salt
that's
clouds,
so cool.
You seed clouds, yeah, and you make it rain, and that's how you get more rain.
I was
going to
say,
enough.
I like my woman like I like my clouds, because just like LA, where there's no clouds in the sky, there's no woman in my life, and it's making me dry. It's making me dry and withered.
That is a long, convoluted one, Carolyn. But I get it.
Layered, yeah.
Yeah, it was layered.
There was the
I like my women like I like my clouds. On the Toy Story wallpaper.
All right. Aidan, you like your women like you like donuts.
I like my women like I like my donuts filled with holes. From my gun. I don't mean they're natural holes.
Yacht.
I like my donuts. Covered in cream.
It's not.
No, they're filled with cream.
I like my women like I like
my
donuts.
They can be glazed.
Yeah, glazed. Oh,
okay. Made out of a variety of wheat-based products.
Can I make the filled with cream one then?
No.
Yeah, go for it.
Okay, because he said the thing about the coffee earlier.
You use yeast to make donuts.
Yeah, but don't.
Because they have air pockets.
It's just not.
Why you got to invalidate my joke? No jokes original, Carol.
Just
not a single one.
They probably use.
You should know. You make a 69 joke every day of your life.
I've never made donuts before.
It's true. You have a problem, and we're
donuts.
Here to talk about it today.
This entire thing was just to make so that the second episode could be your intervention.
This week on Friday Night Bibles. Yeah, we went into your room.
This week on Friday night.
When you're sleeping, so that you'd want to start a radio show.
Hypnotherapy.
On your own.
Not psychotherapy.
You thought of your own.
Psychotherapy is just like.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Hypnotherapy.
Okay.
Listen, guys, I'm in. Psychology.
I was in AP psychology.
You guys should like.
I'm in college level psychology.
Kiss when you're
those are equivalent.
Was
yours
mic.
4 unit?
Yeah,
4 units.
How do you know that?
Because all my transcripts.
For all
transfer
units,
credit
Christ.
AP psychology 4 credits.
You got me.
This is kind of a conceptual one, but I like my women like I like my donuts in the sense that like oh I'll be hungry and. I look at the donut, it's like, yeah, that will satisfy this need, but then I'll eat the donut and I'll just feel sicker than before because ultimately it wasn't a wholesome and good experience.
Hey, we can swing that back to
donuts.
What our theme was going to be tonight, which is Valentine's Day.
Yeah, I really wanted us to like play
this game
songs
has something
of our
to
romantic
do with...
past and,
oh,
and
baby.
Divulge.
I got a playlist.
Aidan, while you were making that joke, I thought of a I like my donuts joke, but it was just the joke you made, but I was going to make it a cannibalism one. I was going to say, I like my women like I like my donuts. I feel bad after eating
them. Well, now that just sounds like you're eating
joke.
Her out, and you're feeling guilty for performing oral sex on a woman, because society
says...
Because
that's a sin.
Yeah, society
you
says...
Really,
it's Friday night Bible
really
studies, guys. We should
turn
study the
that
Bible.
Off when you play this game, Carolyn.
I'm sorry. You mean my...
I like my women like I like my donuts. They're freshly made and you can get them in a store for relatively cheap prices, but it's even cheaper if you get a dozen, and it usually comes in a pink box unless it's from Yum Yum or another, like Dunkin' Donuts, because they have their own boxes.
Connor,
yeah?
You like your women like you like your iPhones.
I like my women like I like my iPhones.
He doesn't
I don't
even
like
have
iPhones.
An iPhone. That's right. And he doesn't have a woman.
I like my women like I like my iPhones.
Assembled in China.
There was no
Are you
process.
Dating a robot?
I wish.
I prefer the term cyborg.
Cyborg.
Organically challenged, actually. This is an easy one. I like my women like I like my iPhones. I get a new model every couple of years.
You're a player, as yeah. they say. I like my women like I like my iPhones. If I hold them too tight in my pockets, they catch on fire.
I like my women like I like my iPhones, because if you leave them, if you sleep next to them, they give you brain cancer.
I like my women like I like my iPhones. People keep stealing them from me.
That's called apple picking. Did you know that? When people steal iPhones.
I like my women like I like my iPhone 6S. The only thing that's changed is everything. iPhone 6S. Order now.
Should we play music now?
No, yeah. I don't ever want to play music.
Oh, honestly, gosh. Music is not good for podcasts, because then we need to get the rights to the music itself.
Greg's got a point. Oh my goodness.
So we can play music as long as SoundCloud doesn't care about us, or it's our music, because I give consent.
Or
sometimes
you can edit it.
Yeah.
I could. Yeah, that's but then you know, it's like, and now playing Wonderwall. That was Wonderwall. Now
yeah,
playing.
That's funny.
Now
yeah,
playing.
That's funny. Let's cut to a clip.
Are you tired? Wait, is my mic off? Are you tired of all this grass in your house? Hey, Dad, why is all the grass in the house?
Oh, son, your mother left us last night, and I just don't have time to clean.
I'm not
the
coming
grass.
Back.
Then you need Eight. Senator Bernie Sanders.
What was that about Senator Bernie Sanders?
Senator Bernie Sanders. Well, did you turn my mic off again?
No, it's on.
Oh shit! Senator Bernie Sanders will personally come to your house and shovel all that grass.
Okay,
out.
I turned
well,
your
I'm
mic off.
I'm sad because my grass is
just kidding, I didn't.
Stop.
I was hoping you'd say
if,
something.
Your grass!
If the red lights are
too
on.
Too
hey, Aidan, what song you want?
Top 1% of the 1%.
What song you want?
The billionaire class. Song. Too many crooks.
Well, that's stressful.
Stealing your money.
Too
as well as your
cooks.
Grass. Here. What am I selling? Okay. Let's make healthcare for the people.
Healthcare.
We're gonna start a revolution.
What happened to Valentine's Day?
We have all taken right. the average
this is
donation
our first song.
Of $27.
Aidan, do you want to explain why this reminds you of your romantic past, or is that just
yeah.
gonna open up?
Well, yeah, this reminds me of my romantic past because.
Is it playing right now?
No.
My mom said
okay,
when
yeah.
I was very young, if you ever touch anybody, you're gonna physically hurt yourself doing it. So don't ever do it. You're gonna die.
Your girl monkey palms.
This was like my song with like
me?
My first three girlfriends.
Me.
You I that is
a lot.
No, that's
what?
Terrible.
It's very
what?
That's not romantic.
Wait, hold on.
It's a broad song. People can project whatever they want onto it.
But you projected onto three different girls.
Yeah, didn't that confuse you?
Not really. No, because
emotionally,
weren't they
like,
confused,
you know,
with why you had so many projectors pointed at them? I mean, it's like it's a bright light. It's that can be pretty disorienting.
Talk normally.
All right,
talk
Aidan.
In a normal
okay,
way.
No, I want to hear about
right?
Aiden's. I want to hear Aiden's.
The people
backstory.
Can hear me.
It's like when you read a book again. It like it you ha- it has a whole nother meaning the next time that you read it. Also, you don't have to find another song. You can just be like, here.
Did you ever tell the other girls? Like,
no.
That's
no
horrible.
Yeah. Everybody right. poops is about the same time.
This is You and Me by Tally time. Hall.
Starting out a road, carefully unload. Open eyed and all the light is falling. Back and forth. And I can see it, of course. Maybe I am in just you. Off again we go, another seat to sew, another part to keep in proper order. What have I begun? Get away undone. I have seen the signs and I ignored them. Now it's you and me, divine, a circular design. Do-do-do-do. Time and place in mind, points along the line. Sitting in the park, carefully remark. Everything is better when you're learning. You were in the dark, and I was in the dark. Everything is made to keep on turning. It's just you and me, divine, a circular design.
Welcome, welcome, one and all. Welcome, welcome.
Wait, we should. Who's the host here? Who says welcome back? Who says welcome to the
it's
show?
It's Carolyn.
This is kind of my radio.
Carolyn's show,
spot.
But we're all equal.
We could do it like a harmony, so I could be like, welcome back.
Welcome back.
Welcome back. Oh, we're not doing that. Right.
And now I'm going to sing you the entire show of Into the Woods.
No, I'm stuck.
Well, actually, I really want Greg to tell this story, actually.
Oh, yeah.
So. The singer in that last band is a man by the name of Robert Cantor, and I know him from his individual work. He has one album out so far, I think, called Not a Trampoline.
But where do most people know him from?
Most people know him from the hit YouTube sensation, Actual Cannibal, Shia LaBeouf.
But he's not even in that.
He is.
He sings it.
He's the one in the middle.
Wait,
that's
is
him.
He really?
Yeah. That's him.
The song. It was a song for a long time.
I know that.
But like, I listen to like the entirety of the album on repeat because I have like sections in my life where I just listen to one thing over and over and over again.
Oh yeah.
And I did that while hiking the tallest mountain in the area. I mean, it's like a huge hill more
what
than
area
like a
are
mountain.
We talking about?
Oak Park. It is Ventura County.
Is that in the Bay Area?
It is an hour north.
Of
almost
Bay
exactly
area?
of right here.
Oh,
wherever
Los Angeles.
Wherever you listeners are, it's an hour north.
Wow.
Oak Park is yeah. You know, I've been talking to this girl for a while and she was like, "Hey, I'm on a hike." And I was like, "Hey, I'm on a hike." And then
you were on the same mountain?
She wasn't.
What? She lied to you?
I mean, she didn't lie, but then she wasn't on the hike by the time I was in the place where she was at the hike at the one time when she said she was on the hike at
well,
the place.
Well, you can't expect her saying the same
Well,
place.
I mean, it was like 5 minutes.
Oh.
Yeah, you know,
well,
like,
did you say
like
wait
if
up?
She if she wanted
did you
to
run fast enough, maybe she's a very fast hiker.
Maybe
she
there's
does
an
do
avalanche.
Track and field now. She does do
or a rock slide.
Whenever I go hiking, I hike very fast because when I was young, when I was a little baby. when my mom would take us on hikes, she'd stop us every 5 minutes to point out a plant and tell us what kind of plant it was, because my mom's a botanist person. So I try to speed through hikes just the fear of someone stopping me to tell me what a plant is.
When my mom don't would take us learn. On hikes, she'd stop us every 5 minutes and beat us.
Greg, I am so
okay,
sorry.
Okay, does anyone else want to play a song from their romantic past?
Okay, so hold on.
This is an original song I wrote?
I actually have original songs on my other SoundCloud.
Is it romantic?
I have like five. Technically, yes.
I wrote it. Technically,
I feel about that.
I wrote it for a comedy sports advertisement, and it's full of references to people you don't understand. And by that, it's one person that you don't know.
It's about one person.
No, it references one person that you don't know. Everything else is incredibly generic.
But you were romantically interested in that person.
No.
You know, I think on this show we should get down to the bottom. Just what is romance, huh? What is it? Where does it come from?
The thing, he was
chemicals in your brain.
He was the clutch gag in every song that I wrote. I wrote two songs.
What's a clutch gag?
It's a gag that comes in clutch.
I'm pretty sure it's like your go-to thing.
I'm going to turn your mic down really low.
Why are you doing that?
I mean, you should keep the mics constantly at like zero, which is the dots.
Go-to thing.
Oh, never mind. It's not the dots.
I want to hear your joke.
I just lied.
Why would you turn our mics down to hear?
Because I wanted to hear the joke.
Oh, so you have to speak up.
Yeah.
The joke was, I think.
I think romance comes from storks.
No.
I think, storks bring romance.
That's where babies come from.
Some avian creature. Maybe not storks.
Billions and billions.
See, I say storks because of the baby thing.
Well, then that's saying in order to have romance, you have to pop a baby out of your bed.
That's exactly what I'm saying, Carolyn.
I mean, basically.
I look through the playlist that I made for this week because, like, I don't know. I'm always assuming that you guys are going to drop out.
I just like to add a disclaimer. That's not
okay.
What I believe. And that's not my opinion. Oh, not to your, to my earlier statement.
To the sexist thing.
And this playlist is called Week 2, Love is a Lie. With a lot of ease. Because when I think about the songs from my romantic past, they're usually...
Oh, no. I forgot to include
the
forward slash.
What is
the
other radio station doing right now? Do you hear them?
Yeah, it sounds
fun.
They're
doing something way more fun than what we're doing.
Hey, look at that thing over there. Wow, isn't that such a thing? Dang.
It actually is, but it's unplayable.
No.
That's a Pac-Man arcade machine. It's in the room with us, but you have to pay real money. It doesn't take lying.
For those of you listening at home, Lion is the currency that we use here at Loyal America.
One of our like eight currencies.
We have three.
That's too many.
Yeah, so
Lion, Flexi,
Carolyn.
S.
I know
S.
It looks like I'm bringing the mics down,
like L,
but it's because I'm bringing the mics
R
down
dollars?
So it doesn't clip.
Yeah, it's good.
L is a part of Lion.
Okay, there's Lion, there's Flexi, there's S. Maybe that's it.
And then there's the 6S. And the S6.
Yeah, that's good.
All right. This is my second favorite song on this planet.
Okay.
It's called Shelia by Atlas Sound. Yeah. And it's about how people just get married.
You know, I actually ghost wrote this song.
It's about how people just get married.
This is not
Do you
me.
Ghost write a song?
Yeah.
Yeah.
There's but not like a specific.
It's about how people just get married because they don't want to die alone.
I mean,
and
technically, if it says that someone else wrote it, then you ghost write
like,
it.
Isn't that the only reason why people just get married? Huh?
Get married for tax benefits.
All right. This is Shelia by Atlas Sound.
My wife, you share my life. You
you know, like in one, it's Groucho Marx talking to Chico, and he's like, all right, you need to sign this. It's called the sanity clause. And if you go crazy, then you can't. He's like, no, 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 you can't fool me. There's no sanity clause.
Oh,
it sounds like, you know, so it's
Italian.
Yeah. Okay, but so he was also like often portrayed as like a, he played like a genius character, you know? So he always was like forced into situations where like, then since like the character is actually stupid, you know, it was very funny.
Wait, so Chico was smart?
So Chico plays a character, you know, because Chico is yeah, like plays like a character, and the character is revered by everybody for being intelligent. Like he's like a super spy, you know, like him and Harpo are always together, and they're like super spies in one called, I think it's Duck Soup.
Okay, all right.
And but they're both just bumbling fools. Like they're told to follow this guy. And they spend a week going to the ball game, and the guy never goes to the ball game. So they give up and they follow their boss home instead.
That made no sense. Out of context,
exactly.
Right?
Okay. But no, but that's literally it. And he's like, why would you do that? The boss is like, why would you do that? And he's like, because we couldn't find the other guy. Like, okay. That's their logic. And he's like, damn, you guys are the best spies ever.
Those are
it's
great.
Really funny. I think.
So to recap for anyone that was not listening.
To when we were playing
Greg
music.
Greg is having a sort of self-identity crisis of sorts.
I've had this for the past 18 years.
Yeah, because he...
you came out of the womb of and you're like...
And I was like, oh, I'm an asshole.
Who am I?
Look what I did to my mom. Oh, no.
I tore her asshole. Anyways.
So tonight we're going to give...
Aiden had to like rub his face for that one.
Tonight
like,
we're going... really talk about where babies come from
tonight.
Oh, I have a love song I want to play.
Actually, okay. This is a
wait. We
that I
just
wonder,
came back from a commercial break.
Yeah, yeah, I know. But well, I just,
if you were to have sex to one song, what would it be? Because I really have no idea what I would.
The Inception song.
That's actually from Time Crisis, which is not by Hans Zimmer. It was only for the advertisements. Fun fact.
Well, okay, but like it is still, the Inception. They use the blahs in the movie.
Aidan, what song would you have sex with?
No, I don't know. That's why I'm curious.
Ice JJ Fish.
Yeah.
What is
that? On the floor?
Oh, we should play some Ice JJ.
Yeah, we should.
Yeah. So here's the beauty of Ice JJ Fish is that nobody knows if he's real, and that is where I think the pinnacle of limitless humor comes from, is not knowing if something is sincere or satirical. Like DJ Khaled, genius, you know, simply because nobody knows.
I think is 100% sincere.
Yeah, he's
in
sincere.
His stupidity,
but nobody knows for sure.
I watched that guy for literally like two Snapchats, and I'm like, this guy's an actual idiot.
Guys,
he
I know
just has way too
riff raff. Jody Highroller, very sincere.
Guys, I know which song I would have sex to.
What?
Child's Play by SCA featuring Chance the Rapper.
Is that a real?
Yes. Can I play it?
No, we just came back. We gotta play Ice JJ Fish. Ice JJ Fish was mentioned first.
Ice JJ Fish. What song by Ice JJ Fish?
It's the only song that's there.
I want to know everybody's comedy inspirations.
Because I think
Greg said Karl Marx.
Well, it was the Marx Brothers as a whole, but mostly Groucho Marx, I think.
I'm more of a Lennon Stalin type of gal.
Yeah. Very funny.
You guys are dicks.
That's an interesting question.
Yeah.
But it's comedy superpower, man. Everyone has one. It comes from somewhere.
What does that mean?
I don't know. That's something I actually thought about a lot, like my sophomore year, is like what influences me. What about you?
It's hard.
Yeah.
I don't know. What immediately comes to mind, and this definitely isn't the first one. But I used to watch a little YouTube channel called SourceFed. They're not good
anymore.
I mean, I liked them initially, but I think their quality has stayed constant. I just sort of...
Because my friend watched them, and he said, you know, like they had some really good videos, but now, you know, it's just like the same thing.
The initial four people on it were very funny, all of them. So they're all very big comedic inspirations for me. But my favorite one was Mr. Steven Zaragoza. He's a great, funny guy, and he liked movies like I did, and he had a very nice beard, and I steal all his jokes.
Cool. I think there are, I guess, three people. I think Jake and Amir, like, hugely.
College Humor?
Yeah. Wow. Well, College Humor, but also the podcast that they have now.
Oh, actually, you know what? I know about that because their podcast is on this website. I don't know the name of it, but Steven Zaragoza also has a podcast on that website. It's called Cloverfields.
Full circle.
It's about the new Cloverfield ARG.
No, they are the bosses of that website.
Yeah.
Dang. Yeah. So definitely Jake and Amir. I've listened to every podcast they have. And then also, just like this weird, nobody knows about him YouTuber I've been watching since I was like 10.
Who is it?
Zachary Little. I think I.
He doesn't sound like a big deal.
His last name is Little.
Something something Zachary. Huh? No.
Greg, that one did not go well with the audience. We just got the demographic results and they did.
But I think ultimately,
everybody
like,
died.
I think just like your friends and like the people that are around you. I think like the people that I emulate the most are like the older improvisers that I knew.
I'm the funniest person I know, so other people don't really inspire me.
They
at
say
all.
You become like the five people you spend the most time with. And I really
Oh, God. I'm so sorry, yeah. Carolyn. No, I'm like, so sorry.
Because I really noticed that last year, because last year I hung out with a bunch of people who, on the surface,
you're so far from your mic
appeared
right
very racist and very, very horrible and homophobic.
Say your opening statement. What do you mean?
They can hear it and I'll fix it. Doesn't matter.
I don't understand what you're saying.
So, like, you become the five, like, you become like an amalgamation of the five people you spend the most time with. And so the five people I spent the most time with were people who on the surface appeared like super racist and horrible and mean and like cruel and like self-centered. And then underneath, they also looked like horrible and mean and racist and like cruel and self-centered. But that was also just like an act, you know, it was all done ironically because it was cool to be ironically sincere.
Greg, I think what you're talking about is called Stockholm Syndrome.
I think you were friends with the KKK.
And you develop.
But I just like became. I just became actually. Like actually kind of racist.
A guy who's like thinks all of his friends are just kidding, yeah. But he's actually in the KKK.
They wear these silly little bags on their heads.
We can get Griffin
Dude,
to talk about that when
so
he comes on the
funny,
show.
Man.
You guys,
don't break at all.
You guys, you guys are so good, and they're like, yes, I know. We're trying to spread, you know.
He's like telling his friend who hasn't like seen in a long time, and he's like, Jimmy, I think you're friends with the KKK.
What do you mean? No, they're just jokesters, dude. They're joking, man.
It sounds like you're friends with the entirety of the KKK.
Okay, I don't think you're getting it, dude. So like yesterday hello?
You're getting a phone call.
Yeah, what's up?
Hey Jimmy. You want to come kill some blacks?
Oh, wait, dude. Let me put this on speaker.
Jimmy, no!
Dude.
We're going to, like, actually literally murder some blacks. Like,
yeah,
no
dude,
joke.
We do this all
no
the
joke.
Time, and it's so
Jimmy!
Fun.
People are going to die.
Actually killing them.
What if someone
wait,
just
right?
tunes in right now?
People are actually going to die, like, for real.
Yeah,
it's very
no.
serious.
Again.
Click.
Never.
They're just being
breaks.
Ironic?
Wow. Just totally ironic.
That's
yeah.
pretty cool.
Yeah.
Can I come on?
Oh, yeah, for sure.
That's cool. All right, let's go do it.
Later
let's
at
go.
The lynching
Wait.
Mob.
And scene. Oh, yeah. I never got to say my comedy influences. I never really, like, you guys all do improv. You,
yeah.
guys, you guys are very funny people.
As a carrot top.
Sorry. As a consolation, he's buff AF right
yeah,
now.
Yeah, dude, he's so ripped.
So, you know what? At least you
I'm
got that.
I'm not going to Google
he should be your
top.
Body of great.
Anyways.
But not in terms of face.
But like I said, I've never really been a comedian and mm-hmm. stuff. So I just want to say my comedy inspiration is Connor. Because he's the funniest looking person I know.
How does he get his face to look that ugly?
Nathan.
I'm just kidding.
It's true. Do you want to play Ice JJ Fishman?
I don't think we're done.
Honestly,
stop talking.
I want to.
Here's
thing.
What I think about music. I think music is great
when we have nothing left to
yeah.
talk about
okay.
on that topic, you know. And then when we're playing music, then we can actually, you know, have a conversation without feeling judged by all of you people.
I was actually thinking about this earlier this week. What Star Wars character you looked up to? Well, this is a lot about you. Because I looked up to, like, Obi-Wan and
R2-D2.
Count Dooku.
Count Dooku?
Because here's the thing, like, Count Dooku is, like, so, like, prim and proper and, like, cool. And he always had, like, the
he
most
trained
precise,
Qui-Gon.
Like,
okay.
fencing techniques.
I only watched Star Wars in April of this year, so I never looked up to anyone, and I need to go pee.
I I think Count Dooku's cool because didn't he like leave the Jedi Order for cool reasons?
Yeah.
Wasn't it like cool philosophical reasons?
Yeah.
Yes.
Well, I mean, everyone basically leaves the Jedi Order for... Because most of the time people leave because they think that the Jedi Order is being just like a bunch of like sissies and like won't embrace the full power of the Force.
Is sissies the right word, Greg?
I mean...
is that an appropriate word to say? Is it accurate?
I can say sissies.
You just think that's the most accurate word?
I mean, what I can't say is...
Wow, Greg.
So
I cannot believe you just said that on
the... it's a little joke. Bleep yourself. No, but so, you know, those are like technically philosophical, you know, reasons for stuff like that.
It? What about when you die?
Well, then you become one with the Force.
Yeah, but is that...
Not necessarily.
...to do that?
Well, like,
I guess you kind of have to choose to do it, don't you?
Yeah, you need to... Yeah, exactly.
Oh, man. All right, Greg, which would you look? Okay, so you looked up to Obi-Wan and...
R2-D2. Because he was a sassy little bee.
He was cursing all the time.
Yeah, I love that, you know, like he never got screwed over. He was never in harm's way. He was always on top of everything. You know, like he had Luke's lightsaber on, you know, like Jabba's barge, you know,
mm-hmm.
like
mm-hmm.
that's what a badass. Sometimes, you know, like he's smuggling that shit the whole time.
Yeah.
You know,
sometimes I wonder if he's secretly the villain because his memory didn't get wiped at the end of the prequels.
Honestly, I think he's one of the more powerful characters in the entire series.
Well, he had all the knowledge. He had that kind of power.
In terms of potential-wise, you know, like, you put him up to a cyborg, and he, like, destroys everything, probably.
But also, he knew Darth Vader was Luke's father
mm-hmm.
for the well, whole time.
Nobody knew that... Nobody saw the transformation of Darth Vader to
except Anakin. Palpatine, yeah.
Except for Palpatine, true. And then, like, Kenobi, sort of.
And the audience.
What about some of the clones, though?
The clones?
I feel like some of the 501st.
Did you look up?
Yeah,
some
no,
because the
they had to pick up Anakin.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Well, that's true, but then they probably died. And if they
yeah.
didn't.
Oh, yeah, Palpatine no, you're right. Murdered them.
Well, also, the clones had accelerated age rate.
Yeah, but they kept cloning them. I found out recently that the Red Guards are clones because they can't betray the Emperor, which is why, you know, they're like his private guards.
Yeah.
Even
I didn't know that.
Even in 6?
Yeah,
wow.
In all of the films, yeah. And like that, some of the stormtroopers are also clones, but not all of them.
If I got to pick a character purely for aesthetic purposes, like to be in the Star Wars universe, I would be an Emperor's Guard. They were the coolest looking.
Yeah, they always had the, yeah, they all looked awesome.
Yeah.
Looked awesome.
They had their shit together. I hope Palpatine designed those. He's like, my special guards are going to look so fly.
More red cloth. Do it. Sue it.
He's just tweeting his new fashion line.
Yeah, yeah. Do you think Star Wars has a Twitter equivalent?
I'd hope so.
Yeah, I do too. They have the internet, right? Something like it.
Forcebook?
Oh!
That ended
we
up
can
being
stop this show.
That
right
ended
now.
Up being a lot more punny than I thought it would be. I thought it'd be like just funny for the sake of being funny for some reason.
No.
Then it came out like a crappy pun, and I immediately regretted saying it.
Yeah, you probably should.
Yeah, I would like to take this opportunity to apologize to our audience for blinding you with the power of bad jokes.
I think my favorite characters when I was a kid. Like, the ones who I looked up to, I don't think... Like, they're definitely not the ones I looked up to now. Because I remember Yoda annoyed me. Because he was, like, going through Luke's stuff, and I was like,
he's
stop
he's a
it!
Crazy old man.
Oh my god, that's his stuff, Yoda, you know? Leave him alone!
He's only ever portrayed in the original trilogy as a crazy, 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 crazy...
Like, he does that, and then
Muppet.
he talks boring stuff.
He's, like, literally a Muppet.
Yeah. And he's boring, the rest of it. Like, he's spouting philosophy and shit, and, like, as a five-year-old who's already seen... the sensory overload that is the prequels, I was like, this shit's so boring. I just want to see more lightsabers.
Yeah.
So I think Kit Fisto was who I looked up to because he had cool tentacles.
Yeah, there are a lot of cool people in the prequel trilogy.
You ever think about what...
But they were always the minor characters because they didn't get a chance to be messed up.
You ever think about what an inconvenient weapon a lightsaber would be for Kit Fisto with all his tentacles flying around?
I think there's a YouTube video on that.
He had tentacles on.
He looked kind of like Davy Jones from the Pirates of the Caribbean movie. Except not really. He had like black eyes.
He was green. He had like...
Oh, yeah. He looked like... Yeah. No, I totally...
Sonic the Hedgehog.
yeah. Like a green Sonic.
Like a turquoise.
Yeah, he kind of had like a classic alien face.
Yeah.
Like the weird
like,
buggy eyes.
Buggy black eyes.
But then...
Beady eyes.
Then tentacle dreadlocks.
Yeah. which a lot of people had, which was always like, how does that happen?
How did we happen, Greg? Huh?
What?
How did we get
Jesus? Jesus. Yeah, I mean, it's Jesus.
That's what you're gonna learn here tonight on Friday Night Bible Study.
Everything was Jesus.
I think it's also really funny that they never say human in like all of Star Wars.
Because
they do in expanded universe.
Do they?
Yeah, they talk about humanoid species.
Well, a humanoid is different from human because it's
but I think humans are
because they didn't speak English. It was translated to our language because we were watching them.
Common speak?
And you know, like their alphabet wasn't the English alphabet, but you know.
Right. So whatever they called humans is translated to humans.
Basically.
Yeah.
You know? You gotta think about that. If it's another galaxy, the chances of them coming up with English are probably zero.
To be honest, because English is one of the craziest. Colonized them at some point too.
if the universe is infinite, doesn't that mean there are infinite life?
Yeah, but there's not infinite Star Wars
that speak English.
In the 1700s, the universe, England reached everywhere.
The universe is not infinite. It's incredibly finite.
What was their thing?
It expands infinitely.
Oh, okay. So eventually.
No.
All right, great.
Everything,
what do you know?
Everything goes out at the speed of light. Everything's moving. You know, the universe is expanding at the speed of light, and it will do so for the rest of eternity.
I'm not.
Which is a relatively long time. Yeah, and that's absolutely true.
Isn't that going to retract?
No, those are just theories. Those are just, and they're not like scientific theories.
So is gravity.
No, but that's a scientific theory, and there's a difference between a regular theory and a scientific theory.
Carolyn's been peeing for a really long time.
She's got a wipe and whatnot.
I guess that's true.
My favorite thing to do.
I forgot people would be listening to this.
What? How do we know if people are listening?
I mean, the
that's the thing
aren't.
Is we actually don't. I wish there was a way to tell. But
all right,
no idea.
If you're listening, tweet at FNBS Radio.
Are you checking the mail?
And I will literally give you $5.
Yeah, someone check the Twitter and mail,
Greg.
Twitter, refresh. Nope.
What?
But the email though.
The email.
Yeah, they probably emailed us.
I mean, obviously.
A bit more formal. I would appreciate it.
FNBSradio@gmail.com. Gmail. All right. So anyways, yeah, the universe expands, but it has like a finite amount of stuff in it. And yeah, like everything is, you know, it's just like speculation as to what happens at the end of the universe and such.
Nope.
No emails.
I was under the impression, and this is like an extremely depressing. Can they hear me, by the way, when I'm talking with you?
Let me check. I mean, it would be nice if
you got a text.
Tell your friends I'm listening, but I don't do Twitter or whatever. I want my phone. You didn't tweet, so yeah. you can take.
You can email though. You probably have
all,
email.
But I said tweet. I specifically said tweet. So you can take all $5 wanting of yourself, and so, go not have $5.
Also, please don't tell Carolyn that we are reading our private phone messages. All right.
I mean, you know.
Wait, who is that?
Rude.
Is that Victoria?
Stefani?
All right, I don't care.
It's not rude. It's, I mean, you know, you didn't follow the instructions.
If any of my friends are listening, they should.
I mean, like, if you tweet, if you get listening. On Twitter and you tweet, I will give you $5.
Yeah, or tweet us. Either or. Or email. Email's the most formal,
but
so we probably prefer that.
I will only give $5 for tweets.
You guys did.
No, I didn't.
You should take your phone.
Honestly.
Oh shit.
Turn
the light
back
on.
Oh shit.
Let the bodies hit the floor. Let the bodies hit the floor.
No.
Alright.
I just went through your stressful situation.
Which
all I want is a little bit of sympathy.
Okay, I have had a song.
Hi. I'm back.
Stuck in my head.
What did you guys talk about when I was gone?
Star Wars.
No, I actually like the lights on.
Well, but it's like a bit, I mean,
it
honestly, it's
like
up to you.
Star Wars.
Don't do that one. That one's bad.
I think honestly.
That one's preferred, yeah.
I mean,
we can play some.
Do you want to play music or do you want to keep talking? Because I mean, you know, we're kind of on a roll.
Yeah,
I
guess we are.
It's like we're on a roll and then just silence and.
yeah, you wouldn't want to cut off this great conversation. What was the song you guys really wanted to play? I want to hear.
Oh, SJJ Fish. Let's play it.
All right, let's play it. Oh, but yeah, Stephanie's trying to break the rules.
My sister says, tell your friends I'm listening, but I don't want to do Twitter or whatever. I want my $5.
Well, that's the first time I'm hearing that, and that is astounding.
I think she's probably our only listener. Hi, Stephanie.
You said you could see how many people are listening.
I thought I could, but I can't.
You're such a...
Shut up. This is On the Floor by Ice JJ Fish.
There we go.
Requested
on the
by
floor.
Connor and whoever else is in this.
Me.
You rock into a Headshots production.
It's something about the girl that just makes my head on a twirl. Oh, you got me want to tell all them other girls. There's nothing else better on this world. The moment I've seen her, I was in shock.
I write a lot of
haikus.
How does that work as a syllable?
That was Ice JJ Fish.
Aidan sent it back, so now I'm a superstar slut.
How do emojis work as a syllable in a haiku?
It's pretty flexible. If I wanted to work as a slut. But like, here's my idea of it. If one emoji works as a syllable, then for that entire haiku, all emojis have to work as a syllable. But if I want them to just be invisible images, then all emojis cut as invisible images.
Isn't that kind of cheating, though?
I think absolutely it's cheating.
Because haikus,
yeah.
Well, it's poetry kind of paints a picture in your head, and if you're cheating by creating things that are separate from poetry.
Poetry, it's just like generic. Are we talking about generic poetry?
Because haikus.
Okay, yeah, because haikus.
What is generic poetry?
Generic poetry, just as in like the concept of poetry, all poetry. Because haikus are specifically, you know, like 5-7-5. Traditionally vowels, now in English it's syllables, but like
was
poetry,
it really, did it used to be vowels?
In Japanese it works out to
Japanese
be vowels
because
Japanese is different.
Okay.
You know? But like, you know, with poetry you can have like visual elements in poetry, you know, like you can have like Shel Silverstein wrote a poem, mm-hmm. called I'm Writing This Poem on the Back of a Giraffe, like on the neck of a giraffe. And it's just really long down the entire page. And
all,
that's, you know, it's because it's part of art, you know,
were aided by
it's an art
drawings.
Yeah.
And books.
So like that one was like specifically, you know, like based on.
I wouldn't say that it's cheating. I'm just saying that I'm breaking the form of traditional haiku.
For haiku. Well, the whole thing with haiku is it is a tradition. So maybe like neoclassical haikus, but regular haikus.
Okay, so I'm.
You're a neoclassicist.
I'm forefronting the movement of neoclassical.
I mean, you're probably showing up like
the spearhead.
About. Yeah. When people expected you to show up.
Yeah.
You mean like so, like the people who know the host really well showed up like 5 minutes early, but you're like 1 minute early because like you're really eager to be there, but like not that eager.
But so, I don't actually know the host.
I mean, not as well as you're not like best buds, you right. know, like you guys work together.
Mm-hmm.
But
somewhere out there in the world, when emojis were invented, there was a poet who was like, "This changes everything." That's cute to think about.
Sharing mic is really hard.
I mean, yeah, but you can both like go in, you know, like.
Can you not hear me? Is that why? Greg?
Well, it's just quiet, and then so because when you talk directly in, the pickup pattern of the microphone is basically just straight into it.
What?
So.
This is a dynamic mic. That means it's like.
Nope. That's not what dynamic means.
What do you mean?
Cardioid. Cardioid is the shape of the pickup pattern, okay. And cardioid means it goes like this. Which I made a shape with my fingers. I apologize to our listeners.
Oh yeah, I did too.
But cardioid makes a shape that looks kind of like a heart if you like filled it full of diabetes and fat.
Which is why it's called cardioid.
Yeah, and you know if you have done math with like complex graphing, you know what a cardioid shape looks like. But yeah, it's a pickup pattern that basically just picks up things right in front of it, and it doesn't pick up things from behind it or to the sides. Which is great for like vocal mics and specific things.
And we're to the sides of it.
You're both to the sides of it talking.
Since it's the Valentine's Day show, you guys can like lean in and then just like.
We can get closer and closer.
You guys
to
can
then kiss and then like yeah.
And then.
I was about to kiss this microphone, but then I thought about all the other people who kissed this microphone.
Didn't Aidan say the same thing?
Yeah, last week we talked about performing oral sex on the microphone.
Of course you did.
Yeah.
I don't want to say what I said last week just in case of our...
There was a lot of visual things,
our massive, too. Our massive audience now here.
My sister.
Yeah, you don't want to bore them.
Thanks, Stephanie. Connie, are your friends listening?
I don't know.
Did you...
Friends, are you listening?
Again, if you tweet at us, I will give you $5.
Yeah. Wait. Can you please tell your sister to email us?
Yeah.
Stephanie, please email us.
You don't get $5
friends,
from emailing
if you're
this.
Please email
however.
Us at F.
Wait, are you saying you're going to give my sister $5?
S at radio at. Wait, I messed it up. Let's start over. FNBS radio, that's RADIO, at gmail.com. That is all one word.
Yes.
Piss.
You guys ever think about when old people die? Sometimes they get really scared right before they die. Like they're like, "Oh no, I don't want to die." I think about that a lot.
There's this cat because like they use cats for therapy for old people a lot.
They throw it at the old people. No. And it kills them faster.
No.
kills them in shock.
No, because like cats are comforting.
The mail?
Cats are comforting. And they just like sleep on hospital beds and stuff. But there was this one cat that like whoever's bed it slept on, that person would die. So like... Well, if you don't know if it predicted the person's death or if it caused the person's death.
Caused.
What color was the cat?
Mm. I think it was a gray tabby.
Disappointing. Yeah.
Well, because, I mean, you know how, like, animals will get skittish right before an earthquake because they can sense that and we can't?
Yeah,
you know?
That's bullshit.
They're more in tune, you know, like, with their environments. So maybe old people smell like death and farts because, like, their body is just, like, just trying to evacuate everything, you know?
Just like
so
Aiden.
maybe it's like, oh, I love this smell. It smells like fish or whatever, you know. And the cat is like, I'm gonna take a sleep right here.
What if Spider-Man, when he got bit by that atomic spider, instead of getting spider abilities, he just got the ability to sense earthquakes coming. That'd be pretty lame.
He just got all the dumb spider things.
Well, I mean, they're pretty neat, but not that helpful.
Six like more eyes.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And he lost his fingers. Like, he just had like nubs.
And his webs came out where it was anatomically appropriate. Oh, also, all of his organs went to his butt.
Yeah. And people were just afraid of him for no real reason.
That was it. People are just like really upset by him, even though they didn't really have to do that.
Yeah.
That I might be a Spider-Man.
And they smashed him with a newspaper.
Yeah.
Until he was goo.
Bruh. I'd smash him with a newspaper.
Oh!
Ow. Valentine's Day episode.
My arm.
Oh my god, no, I'm so sorry. I hate Greg.
When I was three, I touched a spider's egg and I was like a really nervous child as a kid.
Oh no.
And for some reason I thought I would become a spider.
Oh, I thought you were going to say like it popped in billions of spiders. Billions and billions
this
of spiders.
This is Blade Runner.
What?
There's a part in Blade Runner where Rachel, because she's like, oh yeah, I'm not a robot. Like I have memories. There was this time
replicant.
I watched. Yeah. But there was like this time where I watched spiders hatch and the mom spider ate them all. I have memories.
And you're like, you saw that and you thought to yourself, I'm not a replicant.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I can't be.
If you guys ever like spent time just watching
Blade Runner?
No. Mice eating baby mice?
No.
Because I have.
What? It's
why?
Great.
Valentine's Day episode.
Do that?
Yeah. Well, like if too many mice are born, they eat the rent of the litter.
Well, that's like all animals, basically.
Yeah.
They just
really?
And
do
it's
it
so sad.
At like different moments.
Wait.
The baby will be like screaming.
Spiders have like thousands of babies.
Well, a lot of those, like with spiders, you know, it's just babies just die off. You know, like if it gets windy, then, you know, like a couple hundred will be gone or
they
whatever.
They eat the baby? Why don't they feed it to the other babies?
Well, that's the idea is that, like the protein is still.
It goes into the milk.
Oh, because they breastfeed.
Yeah.
Which is why. My parents tried to kill me when I was born.
to feed your stronger brother.
Yeah. Unfortunately for them, I was crafty and I hid in the cellar for 15 years.
Nice.
And by the time I came out, they couldn't legally kill me anymore.
Greg, I'm going to tell you right now, you did not have to wait that long.
What do you mean?
Well, it's always illegal for people to kill you. There's rarely occasions when it's not legal.
The death penalty.
That would
God
be an occasion
damn
when
it
is in fact legal. When I thought of your brother, your baby brother being stronger than you, I thought of one of those Renaissance paintings.
It's not like my baby brother.
Baby with abs.
Yeah, it's like super Jesus baby.
Yeah, it's like that's your brother, and I would have eaten you at that point too.
I mean, if I saw a baby with abs, I would just eat him up.
I would eat the next baby. I see.
I would just eat all the babies. Can I just? You remember that like that cat video? Like, I wish I could have all the cats.
That was fake. Do you know that?
No. But imagine if that was about eating babies instead of like having cats.
Would have had a very different reaction.
Yeah.
Mainly negative.
Okay, going back to the whole eating mice thing.
Okay.
So,
do you eat mice?
No, but rats eat mice, which is crazy because they're so similar genetically.
No.
Are they confused?
They're eat Asians.
Well, they're like, oh, that's a weak baby. I should eat it. Because mice are smaller. And
they
they're like, your tail's all fucked
like
up.
Like, if
it's
we
not
saw
all
a monkey, we're like, oh, look at that poor human child. I'm going to eat it.
Yeah, that's usually my reaction.
Well, one thing that's really cool is that, well, I don't know if it's cool so much as disturbing, but, like, wild rats, if they kill and eat a mouse, they will, like, go straight for the stomach and, like, eat it from that way. But lab rats will, like, crack open the skull and then eat the brain.
Because they know that's what's being studied.
Yeah.
Crazy stuff.
So I fostered two rat babies like junior year. Because
you went through the foster system for rats, Carolyn? Because you did not have to do that.
So I fostered home for imaginary friends.
And because my friend's obsessed with rats. And then they're really cute. And they're like little twins. They named them Dolce and Gabbana. And then like the next day I just like stood in front of all my classes and I was like, does anyone want baby rats? And eventually this one girl was like, yeah, I'll take your rats. And I'm like, cool. And so that was the end of junior year.
Turns out she ate them.
That was junior year?
Yeah, that was the end of junior year. And the beginning of senior year, I had the same girl in one of my classes. And I was like, hey, how are the rats? And she's like, oh, well, he's good. And I'm like, what happened to the other one? And she's like, well, he ate him. But, you know, I just woke up one morning and there was just a skeleton. But, you know.
A skeleton? Was it clean?
Like a psychopath?
No, the rats are kooky.
No, but like she's just like, oh yeah, the rats ate him. Like, is she just used to that?
She smoked a lot of weed, so she had a really positive outlook on
Let's
life.
Let's blame it on the reaper.
She was owned by Satan.
Yeah, just like Aidan right now.
Carolyn, how much skeleton are we talking here?
Yeah. I don't know. I didn't ask her about the state of the skeleton.
You really should have, because like honestly, that's cartoonish what you're talking about. And I don't know if I can believe it.
That's like, you know, like, yeah. Like, yeah.
Thank you for that input, Greg. You're a great hype man.
Of course.
Connor, do you ever think of what song you would have sex to?
Let's cut to a clip. Mama! Mama! Jimmy's giving birth!
Oh, God, again?
But his diabetes is acting up! And the diabetes machine is off kilter, Mama!
All right, I'm better.
Oh, that was solved very fast, Mama.
And scene.
Yeah.
Who's Mama?
I guess that was me.
Aiden was. He just didn't pull his own. Carolyn, what was the question you asked me?
No. Okay, fuck that. New improv scene, actually. We're in the jungle, and I'm the king. Like, you guys are my slaves.
I'm a jungle baby. Yeah.
You're forcing suggestions on improv scenes.
Man, isn't it great? The sun is shining. There's the where.
Revolt! Revolt!
I am stabby, with that
stabby,
guy.
Stabby, 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 stabby.
Bang, 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 bang. And there are bullets everywhere.
Didn't hold my own. Fuck you, Connor.
That scene rested on you, Aiden. I take back everything I said. Carolyn, what was that question you asked me?
Connor adds so much to the podcast.
Did you do 9/11?
What?
Did you do 9/11?
Like, remember that chick? Did you and her go back to your place and do 9/11? You know what I'm talking about? Blow up those Twin Towers, man! Blah.
I'm going to look that up on an Urban Dictionary, because that is, without a doubt, a thing.
No, there's going to be something really offensive
and
gross.
Yeah, and I'm gonna sift through that till I find a sex thing. So,
if I had a nickel for every time I heard that.
Carolyn, ask me the question you're going to ask me.
I asked you the question.
No,
her question.
Okay, because I asked you what song you would have sex to.
What song you would have sex to? That's what the question.
Yeah, I'm still thinking about that.
I had a great one, and I can't remember it.
It was probably Wonderwall.
In the Hall of the Mountain game?
Evanescence.
Yes.
Bring Me Back to Life.
I think I have.
Probably You and Me by Tally Hall.
Wake me up.
Wake me up inside.
Just for you.
Well, the goofy cover. Just the goofy cover.
For those of you just listening now, earlier in this podcast, Aiden revealed that he uses the same song as their song for every single one of his girlfriends.
Not every single one of my girlfriends.
Three out of his four girlfriends.
A large majority.
That is
75%.
Yeah.
I haven't found a sex things yet. A lot of heated critiques of the U.S. government post 9/11.
Oh, I thought you were looking through your playlist or something like that. And you're like, oh yeah, my favorite song, heated argument about 9/11.
Wait, you want me to say my favorite song?
No, I thought...
What song would you have sex to? Would you have sex to your favorite song? Because I would absolutely have sex to the Brody Quest mashup of all the fan compilations.
I love Brody Quest. That's great.
Let's cut to a clip.
Let's...
Do it.
This is Brody Quest. Fan mashup. Just kidding, this is original Brody Quest. I would not have sex with this song. That is a lie, that is a fallacy. That is a fallacy.
Can't even get hard. Aiden wants to have sex to that Nine Inch Nails song.
Not what
the
I
The one
said
that's like,
at all.
I wanna fuck you like.
No,
the Johnny Cash cover of Hurt.
What is
By
that?
By Young Lee?
He's just sad.
Horrible.
Yeah, that's not good. I didn't think about the sex part of it. I was just thinking of Nine Inch Nails.
For a second, I thought you said Young Lean's Hurt was bad, and I was like,
On this next segment of Friday Night Bible Studies, we're going to play a little game called Where's My Panda Bear? Where we're going to look at every single panda bear on the world and where exactly it is.
Pandas poop 40 times a day.
Pandas. For real?
Yeah.
Sounds like me.
They have horrible digestive
Yeah, system. All they eat is bamboo and it does nothing for them. For their bodies. It does very little.
Connor, have you thought of a song you would have sex to?
No.
Okay, because he gave one. I know a song. But
play it.
I don't want things to get too sexy, though.
Do it.
Oh, my God,
Gary. I don't think that's, like, a real problem.
Oh, my song is superior, and it's just going to make you all orgasm on the spot. I don't want
Oh, wait, no. I know what song I would have sex to.
And I did say a song. I said In the Hall of the Mountain King.
That's right.
That's 100% my song.
Okay. This is Child's Play by SDA.
Oh, gross.
Off all my Barbie dolls, tossed them to the side, kept the convertible.
Click.
I like the way it rides up. Can't head it off, skip a wanted boy. Watching from the sidelines, wish that she had it. She wished that she had it. Hearing your back line, built in a fantasy. Fuck reality. Do you wanna know me? Do you wanna know me? Stuck in Nintendo. You're the controller, Street Fighter and such. I'll finish him.
Sound goes free, son.
I'll finish him. I'm Desdemona, Othello and tragedies, Shakespeare and sorrows. Where do
I got L's on my record. Weed on the vinyl. Keys open doors when the keys is albino. Now knock on my door when my stars is albino. I've been fishing for a minute, for a minnow. Only I know that a pawn is a trade. And a rookie for a castle like tuition for a final. Playing hooky for a tassel, spend a minute on a minor. Winds on my window. Ash on my skin when the record low temps feel the wind blow. Only ride rhythm to the tardiest of tempos. Only ride shotgun when the car is a limo. Yeah, see? I crowd surf in a cypher. Scuba in my shower, take a Uber to my neighbors. Used to pay the piper till Peter picked it better. Now the first thing you should tell us, where the hell is all the paper? But memories keep coming back. All the nights that we used to laugh. Wanna know how I used to was, how I used to was.
Memories keep playing back. All the nights we used to love. Just wanna how I used to was. How I used to was. Memories keep playing back. All the nights we used to love. Just wanna how I used to was. How I used to was. Memories keep playing back. All the nights we used to love. Just wanna how I used to was. I used to was,
I used to was.
Memories keep playing back. All the nights we used to love. Just wonder how I used to was. I used to was.
I'm already loud, but everyone else is quiet.
His musical
you band is way too loud.
In general.
And we're back.
I really like coming back in on conversations.
Yeah.
Honestly.
So for those of you who missed out,
which is all of you.
Connor had an anal prolapse
God,
we had to deal with.
Carolyn.
There was blood. I didn't think a human being could have that much blood, especially
Carolyn,
located towards his anus.
If the next joke you make in 5 minutes' time, I'm going to set a timer. You can't know it. The next after that 5 minute timer is up, the next joke you make, if it is a sex joke,
there's
you
nothing,
owe me
Connor,
$30.
There's nothing sexy about your ass falling out of your asshole.
No, that's a sex joke.
Actually, that's
that wasn't
sexy.
A sex
okay,
joke.
Okay, potty humor. Potty humor.
Immature.
Bodily humor.
Bodily humor. Good one.
I'm setting the timer. I'm doing it right now.
Wait, what happens if I do it?
You owe me $30.
No.
I was going to make it $30 million, so be thankful.
There's Your Girlfriend Sucks by Real Big Fish.
I know that. I know the Real Big Fish. I got a friend who's a big fan.
A real big fan?
I don't have sex to that.
Okay. Does Your Girlfriend Suck? Is it like she...
All right. So this is a song that I would have sex to.
Wait, don't actually play.
Don't do that.
Right, Carolyn, no, that wasn't my real answer.
No,
well, I was typing.
That was the German national anthem for anyone who was wondering.
Das Wiener Schnitzel.
I mean, that's incredibly racist. How dare you?
Guys,
wait, this is for real. Have you guys ever masturbated to like a song or a music video?
Oh, yeah.
No. German national anthem.
Oh, yeah.
I don't want to talk about it.
Bitch better have my money.
Guys, I got to be honest with you. I think I have the best sex song right now.
What's your sex song?
In the Hall of the Mountain King. Like 100% mine is the best.
I feel like that's kind of rapey.
I'm still
like, what?
Okay, have you heard? Think of it. Dun, 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 dun,
yeah,
dun,
it's very
dun,
ominous.
Dun, dun, dun,
no.
That is Bill Cosby at the bar.
Oh no, I don't think so.
Slip on the pills and the drinks.
Don't fight with the soundboard.
Don't fuck with the sound.
Scream in the mic. My pants. Okay, well, I don't want.
Okay. Well, anyway.
I am an audio engineer.
I was saying my sex
I have a right.
Wait, your thing is too loud. I was saying my sex song is the best sex
song.
Well,
I'm still mulling it over.
Oh, Carolyn. Sorry. Carolyn has a picture to show us right now.
She has...
saved to the computer.
Of course it's saved to the computer. It's a computer in a room that only college kids go in.
Carolyn.
Remember? For everyone at home, Carolyn has open on the computer... A frame from that one episode of It's Always Sunny where Danny DeVito crawls out of a couch naked.
Remember,
and the other one is a white guy with cornrows.
It's Riff Raff.
It's Riff Raff.
Remember that whole conversation about visual humor we had and how not
I
to?
I just wanted to show you guys. You guys didn't have to like
we
sit
can,
and explain.
We can,
you guys could have just said,
I mean, you know, if you pull it up, we can see it.
Yeah, but...
Because...
I say my song's the best because it has a build-up. See, your guys' song... were flat the whole time. So
no, I know. Okay, have you heard the fan mashup?
No, I haven't.
Exactly.
So I don't know. But that version was flat.
It gets
good at the end.
Really
but
good.
The flat the whole time is not good.
Like
in the Hall of Mountain King, it starts kind of slow. It starts kind of slow. And then it's like, and then there's like a part at the end where it slows down. It's like, boom, beep, boom, beep.
I mean, his levels are fine. I don't know why you're turning him off. It's just kind of a rude thing to do.
So I think mine is the most accurate and the best.
Haydn's Surprise Symphony.
I don't know what that is.
Well, then you have not lived.
Oh, you guys know those songs that are just like, it's like silent for like 4 minutes?
John Cage, 4 minutes, 33 seconds?
Yeah.
That's a song I would have sex to.
Yeah, me too, I think.
Absolute silence.
He would applaud. He would applaud that.
He would have to be there composing, though.
Well,
or
I mean,
conducting.
No,
conducting.
I mean, he's dead.
He's so dead.
He's dead. Yeah, I think.
Even better.
That would
She's
be
like
a magical night.
Dropped up.
That'd be quite the night. Hey, baby. Hey, baby.
Aidan is Drive by
that?
Milo. Aidan yeah. Is Drive by Milo by the Milo that you like.
Yeah, that's,
I would have sex to that song.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Basically anything by The Weeknd.
Becky by Be Your Own Pet. That's actually going to be my final answer.
Should I play that?
Yeah.
Okay.
The Hills by The Weeknd.
I hate The Weeknd. Okay, Aiden's final answer.
I am a music composer, and it is bloody brilliant. So.
Wait, Becky by who?
Or fuck, Crush on You by Lil' Kim.
We played that last week.
Yep. Oh, did we?
Yeah. What's the song called?
It's Becky by Be Your Own Pet. So at first glance, it doesn't seem like there's anything sexy about this song because it's about
Stacy's mom,
high school,
final answer,
teenager murdering her best friend.
That's pretty hot.
But
It's weirdly hot. Listen to
okay,
the song.
This is Becky by Be Your Own Pet.
After the break, we're going to talk about Aiden's psych.
BFF, and you're such a good friend. But I knew it couldn't last till summer's end. You signed my yearbook, and that was pretty rad. But now I'm getting sick of you, and it's just too bad. I heard you talked a lot of shit about me to your new best friend. But it doesn't matter anyway, cause I'll find a brand new friend, okay? Me and her will kick your ass. We'll wait with knives after class. But you know,
talk about
again with the
nice,
whole sharp
dude.
Cuts thing.
My buddies.
For everybody at home, me and Aiden are sharing a mic right now.
East mic. East mic.
We're growing real close.
No,
because
yeah. I kind of wish
they
I
should
had a
kiss.
Mic buddy.
You don't know if that's real or not.
Yeah.
They didn't kiss.
So my
romance story just ruined their lives.
One time in the eighth grade, everyone was like, "Connor, you should date this girl." And I was like, "Yeah, she's pretty." So I asked her out. And she said yes. And then I was like, "Oh, I don't want to do this."
Did you ghost her?
What is that?
In the eighth grade.
But
what's ghosting? I don't know.
Ghosting is when like
you're a hardcore bitch.
Yeah, it's when you like seem interested, but then you just like never talk to them again.
Well,
like,
I
seem interested.
Calling and seeing them.
It was my understanding at the time that I was interested. However, I wasn't really examining how I actually
you
felt.
You ghosted her.
Nobody knows what shit is in middle school, man.
Yeah, did I ghost her?
You ghosted her.
Well, wait, hold on. What is the definition of ghosting?
Ghosting is when you act interested and you just never like do anything.
Okay, but I thought I was interested, Carolyn.
Ghosting is when like you're kind of like with someone and then you like slowly stop texting them, calling them. You just break off all communication.
Oh, I did that. Yeah.
So you ghosted.
But it was for a week. It was not that long.
That's psychological trauma.
Really, the only thing I did that was real bad was like, okay, because it was a week of school, so it was like oh, we have to go do homework, you know, we can't hang out after school because we're in the eighth grade, so it's like we can't drive anywhere, so it was only really over the weekend that we hung out. So the only bad thing I did during the week was during lunch, We were sitting. So there's this one classroom where you could have eat lunch in at my school because it was really small. So we didn't have a cafeteria.
And no one else was in the classroom.
No. Everyone's in the classroom.
And she was like, hey.
No, Greg, eighth grade, man. Hey, they play a movie on the TV during lunch.
I know some crazy freaking eighth graders.
Mm-hmm. And
I have stories.
Today, on that day, they started playing Land Before Time. And Land Before Time was my movie as a kid. And I think part of me not wanting to enter this relationship was like, I want to be a kid forever, and I don't want to enter a romantic relationship.
I can't have this cutting into my Land Before Time.
Exactly! That's exactly what I kind of said to her. She like sat on my lap and wanted to talk, and I was like, shh, Land Before Time.
That's amazing.
Then, so that she didn't appreciate that. I was not great. And then on Saturday, I was like, hey, I just want to be friends with you. I didn't want to enter this. And she's like, I can tell.
Okay, you didn't ghost her then.
Yeah, you know, you confronted
her. But I ghosted her for a bit, but then at the end,
But you came back and redeemed yourself.
I feel like ghosting has not been well enough established in this conversation for it to be thrown around with authority.
Yeah, I'm still not convinced it's coming back from the dead and haunting people, so. Because I'm definitely going to do that to her.
It's kinky. I like it.
Not like that, Greg.
I mean,
don't kink shame him.
Casper is so sad.
It is
Connor,
the most depressing, honestly. Casper and Flubber.
Wait, no, I don't actually want to talk about Casper.
Are you going to cry?
What age did you guys lose your virginity? It's a question on everyone's mind.
Okay, wait, you all say yours.
3, 2, 1.
17.
17!
6.
But like 3 days.
Greg, don't make those jokes.
16, actually. 16. It was 3 days before my 17th birthday. Greg. No, you have to say.
Back in numb.
All right, I haven't lost my virginity yet. I want everyone to guess when I'm going to have sex.
You're 18 now.
He's 19.
I'm going to be 19 on Sunday.
And which will be Valentine's Day.
Oh, my God.
Keep
We're
that in mind,
bringing
boys and
Connor
girls.
To a brothel.
We're buying
a brothel?
I don't want that. Okay, I'm going to say no to that, so you have to pick a different date. It's definitely not going
to
be 19.
Pick a specific date?
Not a date, but like what age? Let's do age.
Have you heard of the 40-year-old virgin?
Yeah.
I imagine you'd be the 60-year-old equivalent.
60?
Yeah.
The 60-year-old equivalent.
Wait, but I would have sex at 60?
Yeah.
Wow, okay. That'd be fun. I'd do that.
With like a hot 27-year-old.
Me at 27?
No, you're 60. She's a hot 27-year-old.
Oh, okay. And it's a she.
Yeah.
Do you think by the time I'm 60, the institution of the gender binary will still be implemented?
Basically,
yes.
I mean, it's basically been eliminated entirely. So what they are is actually kind of up for debate. But for simplicity's sake, they are referred to as a she.
So you can enforce the gender binary right now, Greg. That's what you're talking about.
Yes, I am improving the patriarchy. Or something. I don't know.
My mind was just blown for a second. But like, I can't even really explain. Yeah, I'm not even going to try
guess
to explain
my, guess
why.
My Virgin. Okay, Carolyn says 60. Mm-hmm. Greg added on saying 27-year-old woman is going to do it to me.
At 60, I was making a joke.
Yeah.
I'm
no,
saying
I know. 21.
Okay.
So that's 3 years from now.
Wait, I thought you're turning 19, like, it's tomorrow.
Yeah, so that'd be 3 years from now.
It's 2 years. 21 minus 19. Because you're 19. 20 would be 1 year. Yeah. 21 would be 2 years.
I think you'll be 20.
Yeah, I got the math wrong.
I think you'll be 20.
So
I believe in you.
Next year.
Yeah.
Big year for Connor next year.
Whoa, hang on. So you haven't lost your virginity. Have you done nothing?
Yeah, basically nothing. Yet.
Okay, then I don't know.
I'm standing behind.
It can happen pretty fast.
I'm standing behind 60 years.
Wait, you know, hold on a second.
No, hold on. Because it depends. If the other person, you know, like, is a certain way, it could be, like, you know, 2 weeks from now.
You know? I don't think I'd want to do it 2 weeks from now.
Yeah, but that's what you say now. You know, people can be incredibly persuasive. And you don't know what life is going to present you.
That sounds good.
That doesn't sound good, Greg.
No,
that doesn't sound
no.
like a good situation.
Greg, you never said when you lost your virginity.
Because I haven't.
We got two virgins in the room.
Okay, wait.
High five.
No, I'm not done with Aiden's comment, though. because I haven't gotten down at all.
Dirty.
You added on 2 extra years.
Here's why. Yeah. Well, you even said yourself, if I was presented it in 2 weeks, I don't know if I would want to do it.
Yeah, but you gave me a whole year.
Okay, here's the thing. Here's an example. Years. I'm not going to name names. My roommate is currently in a relationship.
Gross.
His name. No, I'm just kidding. But you know, he is very aromantic, hardcore Christian, no sex until marriage. The girl he is with is not. She could very easily break him over the next 2 weeks.
You and don't know change that, it.
But I know him and I know her, and it's entirely possible. Entirely possible.
I just don't think two.
So
I think
you never.
Years,
so you never know.
I think 2 years is too much, though, Aidan. I think 20 is a good estimate. Okay, let's think about this. Because I'm transferring schools, yeah. Right? So by the start of next semester, I'm going to be in a
You're
different
still gonna
place.
Still going to be 19.
Still going to be 19.
But new
but
people.
But I could meet somebody.
Right.
Get to know them over the first semester.
Mm. Plow by the second.
Exactly. So that's quick. I agree.
Okay. How I have seen you interact with people.
Okay.
Is that I don't see you as meeting someone and then that quickly moving to sex.
You know,
given that you haven't done anything yet, and also given that you haven't done anything yet, I actually wouldn't recommend going straight to sex.
Oh, yeah.
I definitely wouldn't want to do that.
Yeah. So, like, leaving in times of, like, the bases or whatever.
Okay,
maybe
2 years.
2 years.
No, I think you're onto something. So that'd be my senior year.
There's probably a mathematical equation, like a formula. That's what these are called. A formula that we can use to figure out when Connor's gonna get some.
I think Greg's gonna have sex in 2 minutes.
Yeah, I think Greg might lose it this year. I think Greg will lose it this year.
Do you have any interest, Greg? Romantic interest? Or just sexual.
Funny story. If we're going to go back to storytelling, since I know no one's listening.
This Pizza Hut is not sitting well with Connor, ladies and gentlemen.
But the girl my roommate is with.
The bathrooms here are really nice. They're really big.
Yeah, you can go to the bathroom right now. It's fine.
I might soon.
Was not with him as of a week ago.
Wait,
okay, yeah, sorry. I'm sorry, Greg. Start your story over.
The girl my roommate is with was not with him as of a week ago.
Okay.
No,
Greg. However, she was seeing me.
Greg.
You know. No. And then she meets my roommate 2 weeks ago. First time ever. Meets him twice more
I'm
over that
so
week.
So mad for you right now.
Aidan says bad. As he smiles. And pumps his fist.
No.
Monday. Like,
you want to hurt.
I set up.
I was
like,
thinking about the roommate.
5 different dates with this girl, and every time she bailed,
that's a lot.
He sets up one. And she's like, yes. And, you know, puts everything else off.
So you guys didn't really have, like, an established.
So
like,
we weren't dating.
It's
no.
It's like she ghosted
close,
him.
Though?
Yeah.
Wait, what was your roommate's name again? Actually, if he thought you were just friends...
Exactly.
You heard it here
exactly.
First,
no,
everybody. Greg's roommate is Tom Hardy, star of
What was the movie
Magic
where he was
Mike
in twice?
And Max, Mad Max.
Max
the
Cable's
Thunderdome.
Big move.
Max Cable's big move.
No, but, you know, because I have, like, alternating moments of being a really good person and then not. So, you know, I was just like, you know what? You know, like I want him to be happy. I want her to be happy. I'm not going to make him feel like he's stepping on anyone's toes. I'm going to try and make her feel like she's not stepping on anyone's toes, you know, because
I think that's a healthy thing.
They both
thing
felt
to do.
Kind of bad. Wow. And then I proceeded to try and basically like destroy her psyche.
That's very
bad.
Here's the thing.
Because I'm, you know. I'm good at like seeing what's wrong with people,
classic
and then I try and
Carl
fix
Marx.
It.
Can I?
And it's like,
gotcha. Can I actually give you like actual advice right now?
Yeah.
I don't think that you should like pretend that it's okay with you when it's not okay with you.
Well, it's
because then you just kind of like lash out.
This point, well, because I would do that anyways. You know, like if I acted like it wasn't okay with me, which I've done in the past, then, you know, I'm just slightly more verbal, and then I don't apologize, and then I lose friends. It's a vicious cycle that I'm constantly in. And I am constantly feeding itself.
I'm in the vicious cycle of Pizza Hut digestion right
okay,
now.
Okay, Connor.
I'm at the Pizza Hut. I'm at the Taco Bell. I'm at the combination Pizza Hut and Taco Bell. I'm at the Pizza Hut. I'm at the Taco Bell. I'm at the combination Pizza Hut and Taco Bell.
No, it really establishes a really good who and what, but not a where.
Okay. For my high school band trip, we were going to Arizona and it was absolutely garbage. And me and my friends got really unlucky and we had to sit behind the parents in the front of the bus for the whole entire 1 week that we were just driving around. So we were in the very front of the bus and like we passed a Pizza Hut and Taco Bell. So I was like singing that to my friend, like, I'm at that Pizza Hut. Like this volume.
What is this song? I don't know what this song
It's called Combination Pizza Hut and Taco Bell, and it goes, I'm at the Pizza Hut. I'm at the Taco Bell. I'm at the combination Pizza Hut and Taco Bell.
Were you supposed to say butt?
No, I messed up.
Okay.
And no, I'm not done with this. Stop. I'm not done. And
it's going to be quiet.
Okay.
It'll be fine.
Okay. Well, the driver heard me sing this.
So I don't want to stop.
And he's like, "Hoo-hee! Okay, everyone, quiet down on the bus. We got him." He literally told the whole entire bus to stop talking. So I can sing Combination Pizza.
Did he know that it was... Did he think it was an original song?
No! No! He just thought it was fun. And, like, the parents were, like, hooting and hollering, like...
Yes!
They're like, oh, yeah,
do you come from, like, South Carolina?
No.
But she was in a band camp at the time.
You come from, like, the South Carolina of California.
No, I don't.
San Diego?
No!
Absolutely.
We're the same.
Anyway.
Yeah, we are.
Anyway, the bus is completely silent. The bus was completely silent, and I was just like, no.
All right, so what no one else in this room can hear, but what all the listeners can hear, is the Brody Quest mega mashup that I was talking about earlier. This is a song I would absolutely have
all right,
sex to.
Let's cut to it.
Let's get it on. Called Bel Air.
Move, bitch, get out the way. Get out the way, bitch, get out the way. Move, bitch, get out the way. Get out the way, bitch, get out the way. Bring it back to me. Hit the players' floor for about a month or two. Put a tan on it, dear.
my nuts. I'm so fresh, you can suck my nuts. Swag. I'm so fresh, you can suck my nuts. 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 Swag. I'm so fresh, you can suck my nuts. I'm so fresh, you can suck my nuts. I'm so fresh, you can suck my nuts.
You can suck
my butt.
Dick.
Oh.
Sorry.
I like how we all came up with something different.
Yeah. Let's play a new game that I like to call What's Out the Window?
I was about to ask people more Jesus. About like, the bad relationship stories.
Oh, all right. Let's do that.
Oh, I have nothing but you know, let's give some other people a chance.
So I never dated anybody
except for that one girl,
but it turns out there are a lot of like potential relationships that could have happened that I learned about after the fact, and I'm like, shit, but oh well, I don't really care that much.
See, the thing you gotta remember is that everyone has cooties,
which is actually lice.
Carolyn, since you kind of initiated that, what are your sad stories?
Because we also only have, like, 9 more minutes.
Yeah.
So no one's coming in.
I guess that's true.
We can sit here all night.
I'm so fresh, you can suck my nuts.
Carolyn, tell a sad story. I want to feel better about myself.
Okay. So there was this girl who was my best friend. Huh. And, like, fall of my freshman year, I was like, oh, shit, I really like her. And then over the summer, we started dating, and it was cute. And then she's like, got really grumpy with me and stuff, and I have really bad interpersonal skills and I'm afraid to talk to people, so it's just like, why won't you like me? And then on that same Arizona trip where that
people didn't hear that story.
What?
People didn't hear that story
about okay
that I haven't well, heard that story
when I had to almost sing Pizza Hut and Taco Bell on the band bus.
Oh.
On that band bus,
the song that I know as Pizza Hut and Taco Bell is a Pizza Hut,
a Pizza Hut, Kentucky Fried Chicken, and a Pizza Hut.
Yeah,
pizza
anyway,
hut. Well, she was texting her friend who was a lesbian and just got out of a relationship. So I was like, oh, what's up with that? And then I got a text from her that was clearly meant for her lesbian friend. That was like,
those just mistakes if it was like, don't really like, exist.
Yeah, I'm kind of like starting to hate her. In a way.
Yeah,
like,
those mistakes don't really happen.
Yeah, wait, I'm confused how you accidentally got Carolyn.
I don't
know. It was probably an incredibly passive-aggressive attempt to get rid of Carolyn.
Basically,
that's
maybe.
That's ghosting.
Yeah.
That's just being a douche.
But that is, yeah, it's an awful thing.
Yeah, and then her phone died because she was texting her damn lesbian friend too much. And she's like, Carolyn, I need you to use your phone so I can call my parents. And I handed her my phone with that text pulled up.
Oh, yeah. Nice.
It was brutal.
Yeah, what was the reaction
tough.
To that?
That's tough.
She didn't say anything. She just like turned around and then she gave me back my phone later.
She was like, not much. What are you wearing?
Yeah.
Talking to Carolyn's parents.
Mom and dad.
But so
like,
yeah.
Like she wasn't actually talking. I mean, either way, it's funnier. Never mind.
So that was garbage.
That sucks, Carolyn. That's why I think we should abandon our flesh bags. And we should put our brains into the internet where we can transcend to a higher level of consciousness.
Have
we are not
read?
Tethered to such earthly needs as sex, as needing to have babies.
She was
we
also,
can question
I mean,
the needs of the universe!
I mean,
she was my best friend, too. And then she wasn't.
So fresh.
That was pretty sad. And then my senior year. Okay, so I really like this boy. At the beginning of junior year.
It was the same person.
Yeah. And then we started going out, like, beginning of senior year. And then he, like, ghosted me, too.
So, shit, yeah. And he was my best friend, and then
but
he wasn't.
Have you guys ever ghosted?
No.
Okay, define, because, okay.
I've definitely.
One time, is ghosting like live catfishing?
Not at all.
All right.
Catfishing.
Okay, this is
no, because catfishing is like you pretend to be someone online.
No.
Yeah, no, that's what it is.
As what this conversation is
like,
defining as
IRL,
ghosting.
Like you pretend to be
people from the dead.
Basically,
is you like kind of stop texting people, you stop calling, you just
I've never done that.
Don't give anyone closure. Just kind of fade away.
I'm super about closure.
Yeah,
like I'm like really dramatic and shit.
Yeah, that's my favorite TNT original program, Closure.
Like, I'm really stupid about that.
But Carolyn, have you ever... No, that's not stupid. I think that's a nice... That's like a nice way to be. It's like,
look it up on IMDb, ladies and gentlemen.
Have I ever ghosted anyone?
Yeah.
Probably, because like I said, I'm very bad at interpersonal relationships. And I think a lot of that stems from past relationships. And but I'm working it out with my therapist. We're trying to figure stuff out.
I need to get one of those.
Yeah, you should go to SPS. They're really good.
Student Psychological Services.
Yes.
I don't know. I don't trust the people on campus.
Yeah.
Why not?
I don't know. I just don't trust them.
That's fair.
Why, Aidan, have you ever ghosted someone?
You know, they're
I'm not.
In school. I'd rather get someone who's like, you know, just working with regular people instead of like students, you know, so they don't have this mindset of all of these college students are X, Y, and Z, because a lot of college students are X, Y, and Z.
I think most psychiatrists just have that.
I mean, yeah, but like, When your clientele is only a specific group of people, you're going to notice a lot more things.
Isn't that kind of what psychiatrists do?
Yeah, well, like marriage is.
There can be like marriage, and there can be, you know, like school psychiatrists, but those are like for specific. You can also just have a regular psychologist.
Psychiatry is like medication.
Yeah.
Psychology, a psychologist, it can just be like a psychologist, and they have guests and clients of not guests, clients. They have clients of any type and every type of varying things.
You know? And then they can write a movie about your life, and it's called A Beautiful Mind, and they make billions of dollars, and I don't make a single cent. I did a lot of math for that.
A Beautiful Mind? That's about Russell Crowe.
No.
No?
That's Russell
She
Crowe's...
believes it, though.
That's Russell Crowe's biopic.
No, A Beautiful Mind, that's the one where Russell Crowe plays the mathematician.
Yes.
Oh my god. Wait, one second. What do you think I think A Beautiful Mind is about, Carol?
Matt Damon. No.
Psychology. I mean, in a way it is because he has schizophrenia, but like, it's not about therapy.
No, it's not.
So it's pretty...
But it's definitely not about Russell Crowe.
Oh my god. He's the main character.
He's an actor.
Really what?
No, you know what? I think that sometimes it's like a movie's just about the actor in the movie. Like The Revenant.
Right, bitch.
Asshole, Aiden.
Just
broke my chair.
Uh-oh.
Anyway, God.
Continue.
The Revenant isn't about a guy in the wilderness. It's about Leonardo DiCaprio in the wilderness trying to get an Oscar.
Winter's Bone. I've never actually seen that film, but I've heard it's actually kind of good.
Do you guys agree with me?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Because, like, I kind of, when I'm watching that film, there's kind of this meta thing about, like, how far could we push Leo to get an Oscar, you know?
He crawled into a horse.
Like, I think we could get him to go further horse? If we, no.
Was it a real horse?
I heard, yeah, but I don't think so.
We should ask Bryn. She's an expert.
Oh, yeah.
Have you guys seen the John Fairview movie? I think it's called Chef?
Nope.
Yes. That's John Favreau?
Movie. Yeah.
Bad movie.
I haven't seen it.
Do you agree?
Well, why do you think it's a bad movie? I want to hear what you have to say.
I think I know why you brought it up, which is that it's just about, even though he's fronting like, oh yeah, I need to fall back in love with making food again. Mm-hmm. It's really about him falling in love with making movies again.
Yeah.
Cause
it's a
like
metaphor for filmmaking.
Yeah. Because he like,
cause he went through some shit with Marvel.
Yeah. He did Iron Man and that was like a huge, success, but, critics didn't like it. And so like the food critics were like, yo, in the movie, the food critics were like, just blowing down his self-esteem.
But why don't you like it?
Why don't I like
it? I was going to say that part can seem all cool and stuff. Now you just seem like you're an expert and you're single.
And I don't like it?
Yeah.
I guess... Just
have everything covered.
I think just... Parts of it were good.
Showing up.
For one thing, I didn't like how many celebrity cameos there were.
That's true.
Just for no reason.
Oh, I cameoed
in it. The
whole
thing with celebrity cameos is that they don't have a reason.
I know, but it was every single character was a celebrity cameo. So that was annoying. And then also, I think there were a couple, like the ending was a little bit annoying, where like the guy was like, I thought we were friends the whole time. I mean, A, that's unrealistic, but B, there was nothing to say that that might be the case earlier on in the film.
Spoiler alerts for Jon Favreau's show.
You don't need to watch the movie.
Some people might want to. All right, in.
So yeah, that's why I didn't really like it.
But I mean, like, it wasn't written for the plot.
It did make me want to get into the food truck business. I'm completely serious. I really want to get into the
food
truck
business.
That's
a hard game, bucko.
Yeah?
Let me tell you.
You need a really big truck.
Not only do you have to pay for food expenses, you gotta pay for gas.
That's mine.
Connor has
And also,
here.
And here's another thing. It was clearly written by an older person who thinks that social media is magic.
Oh, yeah, that's probably real.
That's true. That's very true.
That's another thing, too.
It's like, was he ever like, let's tweet it?
Well, no, like, here's the... His character's I'm going to keep spoiling this. Basically, what happens is his kid, who... is like a great social media kid, just because he knows how to
use Twitter.
So he
has autism.
his kid, like, they're like, oh my god, like, how are we gonna make money? And his kid is like, I've been tweeting about this, like, that we're blowing up. So basically, just because like his kid knows how to use Facebook,
why was he tweeting on Facebook?
He was using a lot of sites. He was a whiz, mind you.
I like the setup.
So, yeah, so, like, I didn't like that I didn't like that idea that, that was just, like, the...
There was just a very visual joke. My apologies to the audience.
We should tweet the pictures of us doing our visual
I think
jokes.
We should do the world's first ever audio-only Let's Play.
I have so many...
Yeah, let's play Pac-Man.
Qualms.
Boop, 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 boop.
With.
I didn't realize I would get that much silence from you guys. I thought
because like
a chuckle or something.
Because like
rough that's, crowd.
It's like because like a Let's Play is basically entirely just audio. You know, like unless it's shitty and people are like, wow, look at those colors. Sonic the Hedgehog has feet.
Yeah.
Tiny spikes, you know. It's like, you know, then watch a walkthrough. You know, if you want to watch a Let's Play, you watch the Let's Play for the people.
Right, but
I'm gonna pee real quick.
They make commentary on the video, so
sometimes
you're mainly watching it for the audio. However, so at points they will make commentary on the video.
That's true.
Yeah,
but I mean, you know,
so
like it's
sense.
It might be like a. I don't know the split, let's say it's like 50-50. Mm-hmm. That still is 50%, you know, that would work. Uh-huh. And then 50%. I don't know. It's just like... visuals only Let's Play?
Mm-hmm.
Just like really bad gameplay.
Or, that, yeah, it's just a walkthrough, basically.
No, but like a walkthrough is like thorough. Let's Plays are not, like, at all, you know?
I gotcha.
Because let's plays are like
watch
people
for the character,
exactly,
like the, yeah,
the presenters.
We're starting up a new segment here on Friday Night Bible Studies called "How Many Degrees Do You Think It Is Outside?"
Let's cut to a clip. Why do you always
Greg
do that?
Greg says 7 degrees.
Why do you always take my jokes away from me? It's the one thing I love.
Maybe we should cut the mics while you guys hash this out.
It's Saturday morning.
I have a passionate kiss.
It's Saturday morning Bible studies.
What?
Let's keep this going to Sunday. Am I right?
7 ways to Sunday. That makes a
why
week.
Isn't anybody filling up the 12-2 spot? What's up with those people?
It's supposed to close now and then start again at 6.
Oh, but we can do whatever we want.
Yeah, I don't think they care. So I'm going to keep using this audio equipment.
Oh my.
No, okay, Connor, see, please stop. Like, I say stop, like, jokingly, but no, please don't do that anymore.
Let's start a new segment called Count the CDs, where we count how many CDs there are
like
in
three,
the world.
At least
10.
We'll start with this room. All right, Carolyn says 10. Greg, you going over or under?
I'm going under.
I'm going to match that bet. And I'm going to put 50 down.
Shit. I can't count that.
I fold.
Yeah, I fold. Good job.
I'm all in. We're playing a new segment. It's called Let's Break Technology.
Okay.
I'll start with that computer screen. Oh, no! Oh, goodness. This got out of hand real quick.
Wait, no, don't. Oh.
Uh-oh. Carolyn cut my mic.
No.
I'm going to break this microphone. I'm going to do it. No. I'm going to break it.
He's not actually breaking
I'm doing
mic.
It.
Okay, no, but like, what
watch
if someone
magic
breaks
happens
the mic?
And
they like,
talk directly
no,
into this.
DJ broke the
no,
mic.
But we got witness testimony.
Yeah, that you broke
that
the mic.
That computer's probably secretly recording us. Video.
As per usual.
Oh, always.
Yeah, I mean,
if you Jensen people at home don't know, the government's always watching you through your computer, even if the little recording light.
Gotta shave all your eyebrows so they can't take DNA samples.
Hold up, Aidan locked himself out like a pussy,
and he brought his phone like a practical person.
Ooh,
a sweet Carolyn Burch. Let's cut to a clip of Carolyn getting locked out.
Oh shit.
Oh, Connor, you're great.
Hey, guys. Guys.
Hey, do you need help?
Yeah.
I'm okay. We're filming the KLXU thing, the like important actual radio thing.
I'm a KLMU DJ. I don't mean to.
So you're doing the online radio, not the real radio station?
I mean, yeah, it's whatever.
Okay, next time, if you could not cut into our time,
I'm really sorry,
appreciate that.
But I have a show to get back to.
Didn't you bring your phone? Don't you? I saw you walk in with your little white boy cronies onto your show.
No, why would I? I mean, they need my phone.
They need your phone?
Yeah, for plot reasons that haven't been explained yet.
For plot reasons? What are you doing, a fucking War of the Worlds reenactment? Because they didn't have goddamn cell phones back then.
That's I mean, I don't understand what your point is. Look, can you let me in?
Yeah, I already let you fucking in, all right? I'm just saying.
You're standing in the doorway.
Well,
you know,
I'm trying to let you know. Don't interrupt my fucking show.
All right. Look, I'm sorry, okay?
That's all I wanted.
I'm sorry.
That's all I wanted. Get the fuck out of my face.
Yes, sir.
Hey, Carolyn, welcome back to the show. How was the potty? How was pooping?
It was nice.
Yeah? We heard you talking to somebody out there. Did you meet someone new?
No.
Are you sure? Because I think you...
No.
Are you fucking talking about me on your talk show? Carolyn, who is this?
Oh, I don't know. I don't know.
Look, never show your face in this town again, motherfucker. And scene. Yep, Aidan just like, bailing on every... Oh my God. Bad.
Anyways, you're still muted.
I like the lights down.
I don't like it with the light on. That's a sex
I'm
joke.
So fresh, you can suck my
people
nuts.
Are self-conscious about their bodies.
Okay, hold on. Serious question.
I mean, fluorescent lights.
Weird question,
great.
Maybe.
Yeah?
When I look at my penis...
Tell me more.
It looks small. Okay. Smaller than it actually is.
Okay, if so I a see, new segment on Saturday morning
no,
Bible studies
this
is,
important.
If I see the same size penis on someone else, I'd be like, you know, like that penis looks larger than my penis.
Here's something that I learned.
Am I the only one?
No, I know exactly what you're talking about.
Because like,
but
that's
you
such
know,
a
penises
strange
change.
No,
like,
but like,
yeah.
No, but like, just like flaccid. It doesn't matter how it is. It always looks smaller. Than, you know, like other things that are the same.
Maybe it's perspective.
Size.
For short.
I learned recently is that flaccid penises that are smaller flaccid than other penises that are bigger flaccid grow a lot more when they're erect.
Well, that's just because, you know, everything tends to average out.
Yeah.
That's not saying that you'll end up with a bigger erect penis if it's small. It just means that because you have less to work with, it'll end up being about the same length, which requires more percentage growth. If that makes sense.
I don't know if that's what you're talking about.
We're starting a new segment here on Friday Night Bible Studies called
I'm talking about
What Strange Growths Do You Have on Your Body?
I'm uncircumcised, just throwing that out there.
Like, me too, bud.
Yeah. Like
my, East Mike!
Mike, repping the foreskin.
We should be the uncut.
Unrated, uncut.
I don't know. We'll think of something.
That's the shitty cut of the 40-year-old version. Don't watch that version. It's not very good.
Yeah, if Judd Apatow does an uncut version, it's just really long and boring, and he thinks it's
timing.
He's about the only one.
You know?
Do you find having an uncircumcised penis to be a good thing or a bad thing?
I really don't care. Pretty indifferent.
Yeah.
Why would you care?
Okay, so...
It's like, you can't control it.
Almost all of the girls I've dated have been Jewish.
Interesting.
So, like, sometimes they're thrown by it. But like
they're just like, that, like, whoa.
Yeah. But I think that actually it's
you win in the long
more
run
more healthy. Yeah,
I mean it's not to necessarily like uncut in terms of health, but just, you know, because it's all about user experience.
I want to stop talking about penises, guys. I'm gonna be honest.
No, wait, I'm interested. Do you guys penises float in water?
I mean, water. human bodies are like 70% water. Okay. So I mean,
does the human body float in water?
Wait, no, but like, does your dick you mean, float up?
Yeah, does the dick float?
Like,
up?
Like, is that like a point of buoyancy? No.
Well, like,
there's not that much mass.
I don't know, because like you always wear bathing suits, so like
you never take a bath.
Not in recent memory. Not since I was like 4.
Yeah, wait.
What?
Not since you were 4. Yeah,
I mean, maybe.
It floats a little bit, 16. But not, it doesn't go like completely vertical. It just like kind of hovers a little bit.
Like, yeah, like there's no, it's just, it's, I would say the answer you're looking for is no.
Okay.
You know, like it's not like weighed down any extra, mm-hmm. you know, but it's because it's underwater. And so there's like different gravitational effects.
If the Russian mob ever wanted to throw me in the Hudson, they wouldn't need a cinder block because my balls are made of steel.
If they attached a cinder block to my penis, it wouldn't be enough to drown me.
I don't understand.
Because they need to throw me into the river.
Oh yeah, just a cinder block wouldn't quite.
I have a tiny penis.
So does Connor. What? That's what he's told me.
Word on the
what
street.
What are you judging that on? Word on
the street. Aiden, I've watched a lot of pornography.
Okay,
male and female.
Okay.
So I've seen like double the dicks you have, probably.
And the female penises? Actually, always bigger.
Let's say a fourth of dicks.
At once?
Do you guys know about the rule of...
One and a half more dicks than you've seen.
So you've seen 150%
of the dicks.
So you're saying...
For every one dick you've seen, I've seen
1.5 dicks. 150% of the dicks.
A half a dick?
Probably double. No, honestly, probably double or triple because I watch a lot of lesbian porn. Which tends to not have dicks. I'm talking about porn. Is that not what you were saying?
I'm so fresh. You can.
It's the Valentine's Day special.
Yeah, and let's be honest, the four of us. What are we going to be doing on Valentine's Day? But
I'm going to be celebrating my birthday. I'm going to FaceTime my mom
while she's boning your dad.
Are your parents divorced? No, they're married.
Undoubtedly.
I like to think they both pledges himself to our Lord and Savior and are celibate.
My parents have never had sex.
Connor's the baby Jesus then.
What?
Because it was a virgin birth.
Or I was adopted.
Okay.
You're so quick to jump to extremes, Carolyn.
That Connor Franklin Ray is the baby Jesus.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Mm.
Have you guys ever had like a positive relationship?
No. Actually, yeah, no. I've had one. One, yeah, I've had one.
And I fucked it up.
Well, if you fucked it up, then.
Well, no, okay, no, I was the one who, like, in the end blew it.
I think my first, like, real girlfriend.
Sounds so bad. I'm sorry.
Was, to date the healthiest relationship I've ever been in.
Well.
But like I don't, what do you mean by you fucked it up?
Like
how old are you?
16, 17, okay. 16.
Yeah.
So how long did you guys date?
Like a few months.
Cool.
I want to say like three.
What'd you do?
What? You like, what'd I do to fuck it up?
Yeah.
Like, where'd you go?
I basically ghosted her. And then she was like, hey, what's up? And I was like, I don't. She's like, okay.
Dude, this is so much better with the lights off. I really
like it. It feels like a sleepover.
Yeah, it really does.
Because, like, I had really bad anxiety problems. Mm-hmm. And just, like, thinking about someone that I liked would basically send me into, like, a panic attack. And mm-hmm. so, like, I could not physically bear the anguish it caused me to think about being with her. Like, wow. because I didn't want to disappoint her, you know? Like, I cared so much.
I get that.
Greg, it bothered me.
Are you familiar with the existentialist philosopher Soren Kierkegaard?
Isn't that the YouTuber you watch?
No, but no joke. Okay, he's the founder of existentialism. Mm-hmm. And he did the exact same thing to the love of his life. He was afraid he would disappoint her.
Wait, are these the people who met at Great Wall of China?
No.
No, fuck.
All right.
They were.
Oh, fuck. Sorry for
they
swearing.
They were Danish.
Yeah,
you should look him up.
It's past midnight. You can absolutely swear.
We could swear the whole time.
I mean, not really. But who cares?
What? You can't swear?
No, you're not.
Carolyn, you know the ins and outs.
Yeah. They said don't swear because there could be Jesuits listening.
Jesuits go to bed at 10 p.m.
Yeah, they got to pray to the Lord on the bed and then they go to sleep.
Yeah, it's Good Friday.
Is it?
It's not Good Friday.
Is it not?
Good
it
Friday is good the Friday, Friday before Easter.
But so that, and also, like, neither of us could drive, and we were leading busy lives, like, half an hour away from each other, which is huge when you can't drive.
Yeah.
Sure. So, you know, I was just like, this is not gonna, you know.
You should for real look up Kierkegaard, because, like, he did the same thing. And he went through the same thing you did. You might be able to, I don't know, get some closure.
And like the anxiety is a problem I've had like in that situation. Mm. Until halfway through senior year, when I think I was basically just like, you know what, fuck it. Like senioritis hit me full force. Mm-hmm. And then I was subscribed wholeheartedly to DGAF for the rest of the semester.
Don't give a fuck for those of you at home.
Yeah.
That's my favorite YouTube channel.
And yeah. A lot of fun. Didn't have any positive relationships, but I had a lot of fun.
Yeah.
I know all the romantic and sexual relationships I've been in have been garbage, and I regret all of them, so there's that.
I mean, I think I've learned things.
Absolutely.
No, I feel like I'm just making the same mistakes over and over again.
Well, absolutely, yeah. But you learn what those mistakes are, and then you're like, next time, and then you figure out that it's actually something else that leads into that, so by the time you think you know what you're doing, then you don't, and then you're like, next time, and then there's even more shit, and you never win, and then you die alone, and you're
that's
sad.
Right. Or maybe you marry someone just because you two are the only people, you know, and society says you have to get married, and you marry someone, but you never really love them.
Or don't follow your heart, because you know your heart will lead you astray.
That's right.
But, like, if someone has, like, a crush on you, then, like, just go with that shit.
Also, if you meet a half Japanese, half Italian woman, just jump on that as soon as possible.
It's not. Nice. Then it's not you fucking up.
Aidan, you want to expand?
No, okay. I just want to throw
really,
that
no.
out there.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let's cut to a clip.
Ah!
Oh my god.
It's on fire!
Don't say what's that on the air. Oh, shit, the air. Everyone knows the radio is equivalent to a crowded theater.
It's not on fire. It's just very, very hot.
But it's lit.
What's on fire?
Oh, East Mike!
I cut your mic. I cut your mic because I hate you.
We took out Midwest mics. So.
Wait, for real? No, put our mic back on.
Your mic's back.
We made a great joke, and Carolyn was jealous of our talent.
Yeah.
A little bit.
Bringing us down.
Who's that?
Are people still listening?
No, it's Matt, you know, Dylan's roommate.
Yeah.
He's like, stop podcasting.
Let him know. Caps. Let him know we're playing.
No.
You should.
No, he just asked me a question about fraud because he's really dumb and he never goes to any of the meetings.
This is being recorded.
Okay, also,
I mean, he's still a good guy. He's just like, I'll be there, and then he's never there.
Oh,
so.
My God. He's just saying this.
People.
This is awful. You know, this is going to end up on SoundCloud. Everybody goes on SoundCloud.
People are going to look you up.
Wait, was our first episode on SoundCloud?
Yeah.
Yeah, I put
Taken
it up.
Off.
No.
I said some disparaging things about some of our fellow LMU students.
Yeah.
I'm going to listen to that.
It's just one disparaging comment.
I mean, and then...
Who is it?
Yeah, but it's... It was... You know, there were... It was... And we're back.
Beep boop.
That was fun. Did you guys like that silence? We were playing an excerpt from John Cage's 4 minutes 33 seconds.
Oh.
Nice one, Greg.
Good
that
save.
That was clutch.
Now they don't know we're incompetent. We don't know what we're doing with our lives.
Basically.
Yeah. Valentine's Day.
They're not going to find it.
You know what, guys? No one's if you're ever down on Valentine's Day, don't think about Valentine's Day. Think about how I was born, and
no,
either be very happy or very sad about that.
I'm going
to
be very
I'm
sad.
Going to repeat a quote from one of my favorite comedians / philosophers.
Me?
It's me. He's mine.
If life makes you wish you were dead, just put on a good movie, then promptly put a bullet in your head.
Nice.
Oh, I subscribe to that philosophy wholeheartedly.
I feel know it. What that one means to be
and
honest.
Full fistedly.
I really want to.
I don't think that's a.
I mean,
what does Aidan want to do?
I want to divulge more into the unhealthy, healthy relationship thing.
Okay. I don't think modus.
With I'm down. Honestly, like,
I don't think modus ponens. That's modus ponens argument.
We've reached bonus hour.
That's right. It's not Saturday morning Bible studies. Time.
Which means you guys get extra, but you have to pay.
And there's going to be like an 80s like
this
song.
This does not come
like
as part of the free time. You actually have to pay by the minute. So if you're this far into it, you already owe us
$40. Okay. You talk about negative, healthy relationships and that.
Anyways.
Since you...
Like what specifically are you referring to with the whole...
It was very comical, the whole situation.
Yeah, she was a clown. I was dating Ronald McDonald, actually.
Oh, no.
Thought she was a chick.
I was
completely
dating Ronald
Reagan. My sexuality.
Sure.
Rule 67?
There's porn of it. Is
that no, that's a gender bent porn.
What was the purple?
34 is.
The purple spot?
Grimace.
The one in the McDonald's thing.
Yeah, grimace.
That's grimace.
Yeah, it's
the
grimace.
Entire McDonald's universe is horrifying.
Okay. The Hamburglar is my favorite.
Okay, wait. Aidan, let's go back.
Now I want to talk about the hair.
All right, who's the one who had like fries for hair? Like she was like a paper mache chicken with fries for hair. What
was
the fuck
the
was up with that? Yeah,
no,
she looked like Satan. Satan incarnate.
Like a weird purple penguin.
Chicken. She was like a white and yellow chicken.
Chicken?
Yeah.
She was selling like McNuggets?
I don't know. She had like fry hair. Like racist goodness. Like dread shit.
Oh, no.
Like it was like, and like she had like a beak, which looked like...
Her name was like, which
no, this is gonna
like,
get.
Like,
I'm gonna look up.
I was going to look
this is gonna sound incredibly racist, but it's because it is. Black people lips?
Yeah.
Yeah,
oh,
like a racist
no.
stereotype.
Yeah, you know, and she was like,
face. Give me mo.
When
chicken.
Did they eradicate all of that?
I don't know.
There were like a whole bunch of riots back in the 90s.
The Rodney King. Oh, no.
I'm sorry. That was
like,
bad.
That's
that was
not
bad.
Because I saw them when I was a kid. Had they just not gotten rid of them?
The blacks? No.
No! No!
My favorite. I remember this tweet that you.
That was. I'm
going to reference a tweet that you said. It was like, I'm not convinced that these quote-unquote gays are any different than these quote-unquote
yes. Yeah.
Back to healthy, unhealthy relationships.
Yeah, so...
One time, I almost had sex in a Mormon church. Boy,
that
was that
real?
A story. That is
out.
That is absolutely a real story.
You need
they
to
don't
fucking
let,
say that.
They exactly. don't let us in.
They don't. But
they don't
I
let us in the temple.
So the principal's son.
You're such a fucking idiot, Greg.
The principal's son.
Oh my god.
The principal. I hope no Mormons are listening. Mormons, if you're listening, I'm sorry.
I'm not really sorry.
Oh, okay.
What are we looking at, guys? Hey,
they're saying the wrong mascot names. So I was about to say her name is
oh.
Avis Piens, but that's not it.
Wait, I want to hear about the Mormon set.
So, okay, so the principal's son was on our comedy sports team. He was the most uncharismatic, worst, but you know, principal's son. And it was like a spring break get together thing.
Donald says Mickey. I just like to interject that.
And it was like we were like, you know, meeting together to play like dodgeball or some shit. Cause who cares? But then it started raining and the principal's son was like, hey, Mormon church is nearby. Let's go into the gym because half of it's a basketball gym, like a full gym, and play basketball. And everyone was like, okay. And I had been like flirting with this chick on the team for a while. This is the same person as the hill girl. She was something else. I mean, she technically still is something else, but
hubba.
Fuck up in that church.
No, okay, but like, so we got quote unquote lost. The whole thing is fucking symmetrical in all four directions, which pisses me the fuck off.
The Mormon church.
It has this exact same shape of corner rooms and like distribution of side rooms, and has doors on all four sides, even though one of them like just like goes straight. I don't know why, but it is. But like half the church is used like more than the other half, but like the building originally. It's so weird. But so like a whole bunch of dark rooms.
There's a McDonald's character called Uncle O'Grimacy.
That sounds really
is
he rapey.
Irish?
I'll look that
in reference to Uncle Tom's Cabin?
yep. I just read it.
Wait, I want to hear about Greg having.
I'm sorry. I
didn't have. So like we started fooling around, and then we heard footsteps and knocking and like Greg, person's name. Greg, person's name. And we were like, oh fuck. So like she gets up, puts her shirt on.
Do you see your titties?
Bruh. Notice how I didn't answer the question.
Carolyn, if you were a McDonald's mascot, you'd be trash cans.
God damn it. No, but like she like left the room and was like, hey, where's Greg? And they're like, I don't know, we're looking for him.
Oh, that's smart.
I would never thought about that. No, so then the person she was talking to then immediately went to the room she came out of and opened the door.
Oops.
And there I was, zipping up my jacket, which looked like I was zipping up my fly.
Oh,
so she was like, put your pants back on, and I was like, fuck. You know?
Well, you should have just said, no, is my joke.
Because I didn't.
In here,
I didn't.
That would have been a little good little in joke with you and your lady.
I didn't, like, realize what she was talking about.
I should write.
And, like why? Until it was too late, and I was like, fuck it. This was in my, like, DGAF phase, though. Mm. So, like, she got fucking roasted. Like, no one was talking to her. And I was just like, I felt bad for her, you know? But I was laughing my ass off because everyone was like, how dare you have sex in a Mormon church? And it's like, bruh, it's fucking. But it's the concept.
Wait,
it's
but
funny.
I still want to hear about Aidan.
Yeah, that was a weird thing that happened.
This is the part of the show that Aidan decided he didn't want to see exist. So fuck him.
Birdie the Early Bird was the first identifiable female character in 1980 to 2011.
She smashed
to promote
so many glass ceilings.
She is a yellow bird wearing a pink jumpsuit and a flight cap and a scarf. In later years, her legs were orange. In the ads, she is frequently portrayed as a poor flyer and somewhat clumsy in general.
Because she's a woman.
Birdie's origin is explained in one old commercial. A giant egg falls from the sky.
What an origin.
Excuse me. A giant egg falls from the night sky into McDonald land. And Ronald McDonald...
What a self-centered
hang
douche.
On, hang on.
Wait, I gotta read this next line. I gotta read this next line, Aidan.
I'll start from the beginning. A giant
Wait,
ape
what's
falls.
Aiden's whole...
Once...
He said Aiden's like, I got a
Let
whole...
Let Connors do the line.
A giant egg falls from the night sky into McDonald Land, and Ronald McDonald decides to show the egg love.
See there. No, it's Aiden's hole. Aiden, show me your hole. Nice.
For those of you listening at home.
I was kind of mind blown by the fact that the McDonald's universe is separate from our universe.
Birdie took karate lessons and is as good
it.
As her karate teacher.
Who's
which
her teacher?
She refers to as Little Bird.
I like it.
Mayor McCheesy was an enormous cheeseburger who appeared in 1971 to 2008. He has a burger for a head and a sports a top hat. A diplomat sash, and a pair of pince-nez spectacles. He is portrayed as a giggly, bumbling, and somewhat incompetent mayor who is based on H.R. Puffsnuff. Puffinstuff, excuse me.
Who's Puffinstuff?
H.R. Puffinstuff. Though the character was dropped during the streamlining of the characters in the mid-1980s, he did appear in a 1999 The Wacky World of Ronald McDonald, VHS entitled, Have Time,
Wait.
We'll Travel.
All right, do you want to play the outro song and then we can conclude afterwards, or do you want to conclude
And a
now?
Non-speaking cameo.
Conclude about what?
In the monster.
Just like,
oh,
be
McDonald
like, hey,
Land
that was Friday night / Saturday morning Bible studies.
Mayor
we unloaded a lot of emotional
Howard
baggage.
Morris.
Yeah.
Check us out on SoundCloud.
Impersonating Edwin.
There's I think nothing. It'd be better if we did the outro
There's
now,
no.
Okay.
And then did the song.
Alright. This is Friday night / Saturday morning Bible studies with your host, DJ Don't Care.
Greg.
Dr. Nurse.
This is our Valentine's Day special where we unloaded a lot of emotional baggage. If you want to really... Fuck. Relive the unloading of emotional baggage, check us out on SoundCloud at Friday Night Bible Studies.
FNBS Radio on everything.
And don't forget to email us at gmail.com.
Yep. Thanks for listening.
The dictionary defines love as...
Thanks for listening.
The smashing of two...